It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Maher family. Peter, Sandy, Gary, Jan, and Lori, ready for action. And the Ross family. Dick, Jenny, Ellen, Renee, and Larry. On your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Lady, it was disrobing during the introduction. Her belt fell off. I got a new girlfriend, you know. I'm a bit worried about her. I think she's seeing other guys. I'll tell you, I call her on the phone. She's got an 800 toll-free number. We have $10,000 to give away, and these nice people were brought in from Boston. The Mars are right out. Yay! How you doing?
How you doing, Richard? Nice. Thank you.
May I meet your family, please?
You may. This is my wife, Sandy.
Hello, my darling.
This is my oldest and only son, Gary.
Hey. Hi, Gary.
Hi.
This is my baby sister, Janice.
Hello, Hi, Richard.
And my sister-in-law, Laurie.
Hi.
We're delighted you're here, darling.
Thank you.
When did we interview you for the show, Peter?
Last July.
What do you got here, Jan?
What we have. We in Boston keep waiting for, Richard to take over the Johnny Carlsen show.
Oh,
so here.
Richard! You got to abuse this about 4 years ago. Thank you.
Thank the you. Lip?
Yeah. Who designed this?
A friend of mine in Holliston, Mass, name of Alan King, has a silk screening company.
That's kind of neat. I like the lips on there, too. I've got to get mine in. Get them vulcanized. You came from Boston, these nice people from Mobile, Alabama, the Ross. Hey! Welcome.
Hi, Richard, how are you?
Thank you, thank you. Can I meet everybody, please?
You certainly may. This is my wife, Jenny.
Hello, darling.
Hi, Richard.
This is Jenny's single sister, Ellen.
I like the way you said that.
Hi, Richard.
Darling.
And their sister, Renee.
Renee.
Hello, Richard.
Welcome.
And thank Renee's you. Husband, Larry.
Hello,
well,
Richard.
Nice to have you here.
You.
Right? Well,
nice to see you.
Did you get in yesterday as well?
We got in yesterday.
You've been here before?
No, we have not.
I better get down here.
Yes, Ellen, the single sister, has a little present for you.
How are you doing that, Richard? How are you?
Hi, Richard.
Nice to have you here.
We brought you a present all the way from Mobile, especially for you.
Kind of nice. Thank you, Donna.
Thank you.
Thank you, Winston. Come on, let's play the feud.
All right.
People surveyed. Top five answers are on the board. You got to try and find the most popular answer, and here's the question. Name something about which teenagers try to negotiate with their parents. Yes, sir.
The car.
The car. One answer will beat it, Richard.
Allowance.
Allowance. Okay, you got control. What are you going to do?
You going to play?
We're going to play.
Okay.
The car. How you doing, darling?
Nice I've waited
you.
For that for a long time.
Well, I'm glad it's all the better. Something about which teenagers try to negotiate with their parents.
How about the hour they can stay out?
Okay, sure. The hour they can stay out.
Oh.
How are you, Gary?
Good.
Nice to have you here. How old are you?
12.
These are good answers for you, but you remember them. Mm-hmm. You can negotiate with Dad and Mom. How late you stay out? Because you can't use the car for a couple of years. How old you got to be?
16.
Oh, well, come along soon. Meanwhile, you could probably use something else. What would you try and negotiate with Mom and Dad about?
Their chores.
You try to get a little less, you mean?
Yeah.
Okay. It's all the chores, Mom. Nope. But so that was a good answer. You don't have to worry about that. Hi, buddy. Welcome.
Thank you.
What do you think the teenagers would negotiate about?
They try to extend their leisure activities to include
It's good.
Alcohol.
This could be a novel here coming up. Try to see if Mom and Dad would let him have a little sip of the booze.
Yeah.
All right. Unless you drink booze. No.
No, no.
Don't worry.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. Is it bedtime? No?
Same thing as good? Bed has nothing to do with going out late, is it?
No,
bedtime, I think, is good.
Thank you.
Good.
Is there all right? And if not, third strike, bedtime.
Boy, that got back to me fast.
Yeah, well, it'll tend to do that. Every four times, I come back to you.
Chores?
Chores and booze. Curfew, use of cars, allowance. Homework time, school, I'm just fishing here.
Well, that's your homework. That's all right.
Homework.
You didn't touch him, darling, did you?
Oh, I don't know if I will or not.
Sounded like he got his Christmas juice a little early there. Suddenly went,
what? Be there.
It was there, you got it. If not, third strike. Homework. No. $95, Richard, give me the right answer. The money's yours.
Okay, what is it?
Come on, dating.
Okay. We're going to go with dating.
When you're keeping that current with your single.
Let's
dating's
so.
There, $95 for you. If not, Peter gets it. Dating. $95, nothing. Let's go. People surveyed, top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an activity groups of people do together at the beach.
Yeah. Play ball.
Well, play ball. One answer will be there. Groups of people, an activity they
have
do.
Have a picnic.
Have a picnic. It's good, it's there. They got control. What are you going to do?
We'll play.
Gary, don't do this to your mom and then say pass. It makes no sense. You either say pass or you say play. Mom didn't know what you wanted. Group activity at the beach.
Go swimming.
All right. Swim! Okay.
Make a sand castle or a sand sculpture?
Oh,
yeah.
Sand castle!
Oh.
Angel, I would have bet that it was, I thought, number one.
Surfing?
Well, I thought you were calling me a surf. We surfed up
come
the
on, be there, be
surf!
There.
An activity groups of people do together at the beach.
Sing.
Brilliant.
Huh? All right. Is there okay? And if not, third strike. Sing! No. $13 up there.
All right.
Volleyball.
We're going to go with volleyball.
Sounds like a good one. If it's there, you get the $13. If not, Peter does. Volleyball. Frisbee time. You good at that, Gary?
Yeah.
Come here a second. Come on out here. You're a nice young man. I want America to see you. Tell him we'll be back right after this.
We'll be back right after this.
He's never lied to you before. Okay. 108. Not fake. Come on, Gary. Survey, top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a kind of target kids try to hit with snowballs.
Squirrels.
Squirrels. Oh.
Other people.
People.
All right. Okay, all right.
What are you going to do?
Let's play.
We're going to play.
We're going to play. And you leave those squirrels alone. Very good.
Hello, yeah. Richard.
How are you?
Fine.
Kind of target. Kids try to hit with snowball.
I'll go with the tree, maybe.
Tree.
Mm-hmm.
Hope
all right. All right.
I hope you'll be very happy. Trick!
All right!
Boy,
how are you doing?
Good to see you. What sort of target the kids trying to hit with snowball?
Well, maybe a moving target like a car.
Okay.
Car!
All right.
Ricardo?
Well, that's a problem. There's no snow in Mobile, so,
Should I come back to you then?
I hadn't seen out any here.
No, we don't get along.
I think I'll go with houses.
Okay. A house! Not that. First strike. Pretty Ginny.
Signs.
Uh-huh.
Good answer. Very, very good.
Throw a big snowball on things that do not throw snowballs. Signs!
All right!
Sidewalks.
Sidewalks?
Good answer.
Good answer.
I was thrown off my team in England. I couldn't hit it. Sidewalk? No. Kind of target kids trying to hit with snowball.
Would ground be considered the same thing as sidewalk?
Honey, it's hard to miss the ground, isn't it?
All right.
The key word here, I think, is try, isn't it?
Right. Oh.
3 seconds.
What about...
Third strike. Want to get in the game? $87 up here, Peter.
Three lights.
What do you say?
Consensus of opinion. Being from Boston with
just give me an
stuff.
Answer. What do you say?
Streetlights.
All righty. I don't want to hear a novel. Streetlights there, $87. That's not a big lead, Richard. Streetlight. Five. Six. Snowman. $195. Nothing. Let's go. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top 4 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something that the fairy godmother gave to Cinderella.
A new dress.
A new dress.
Hey.
One answer will beat it.
A coach, a stagecoach.
A stagecoach. You got it. What are you going to do?
We're going to play, Richard.
We're play, then. Yeah, stagecoach. John
come
Wayne.
On, come on, Mark.
What did fairy godmother keep to Cinderella?
3 wishes.
Okay, 3 wishes.
A gorgeous little pair of slippers.
Good. Some nice slippers. The way to do it, champ.
Coachman to go with the coach.
All right, that's one. Coachman? No. But here, I'm betting
I
on
know,
this
I know, I know.
Yeah, come on.
Something the fair god gave to Cinderella.
Horses.
That day you got it, if not third strike, horses? Want to be the champs? Give me the right answer.
Let's go.
All right, let's hear what
is it?
Need an answer.
Hour to be in.
We think it's an hour to be in, midnight.
Oh, gave her,
deadline.
Gave her curfew. If it's there, you're the champs. If not, game's very even. Peter, you get the 190. Curfew?
Oh!
A pumpkin, huh?
It's
either a pumpkin or a prince, one of them. 4. 195, 190, let's go! going to decide who'll play for the $10,000. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top three answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something specific which dieters eat without butter.
Yeah. Bread. Bread.
Bread. You got it?
All right. We'll play, Richard.
Okay. Well done. Listen carefully. I will not repeat this. When I get to you, you have 3 seconds to answer. There's only two answers left. Here's the question. Name something specific which dieters eat without butter.
Eggs.
Eggs. Any?
Potatoes.
Potatoes?
Right.
All right. 3 seconds.
Fruits,
there, you got it. If not, third strike. Fruits! 270. You'll play for $10,000 if you give me the correct answer. Come on, Peter. Take your time now.
Potatoes.
I need an answer right now.
Potatoes are vegetable, right?
Yeah. Now give me an answer.
Okay, give me an answer.
Meat.
Meat?
Meat. Meat's there, you play for the big money. If not, you do. Meat! That's horrible. I don't like it at all. $190. Do you have a bank account yet?
Yeah.
Got a lot of money in there?
Yeah.
How much?
I don't know.
More than $50?
Yeah.
Maybe you could lend me some money. Well, $190, that's what you've won, and plus $50, put it in the bank. Don't spend it on Pac-Man. All right?
Okay, thank you.
Have a safe journey back. Wish you luck.
Thank you so much, Richard.
Yes, sir. $10,000 in 15 seconds. Name something you do while you soak in the bathtub.
Pass.
Something campers use to keep warm.
Blanket.
Besides apples, any fruit.
Pears.
A soft fabric.
Cotton.
America's favorite vacation state.
Florida.
Something you do while...
Soak.
What did you say?
Soak.
Soak. Turn around. Something you do while you soak in the bathtub. Soak. Survey said. Something campers use to keep warm. A blanket. Survey. Besides apples and fruit, pear. Survey said. Soft fabric. Cotton. Survey said. America's favorite vacation state. You said. Orida. Survey said. Hey, hey. Right next to dinner. We're looking for Richard.
Yay!
There you go. You know, we wish you luck. Please remind everyone the answers Larry gave us. When you stop laughing, give us 20 seconds on the clock. Name something you do while you soak in the bathtub.
Read.
Something campers use to keep warm.
Fire.
Besides apples, any fruit.
Orange.
A soft fabric.
Silk.
America's favorite vacation state.
Hawaii.
Turn around. What do you do while you soak in the bathtub? He said read. It was number one. Survey said.
All right.
Something campers use to keep warm. You said fire. Survey. Number one answer was a sleeping bag. Besides apples, any fruit. You said an orange. Survey.
All right.
Orange was number one. The soft fabric. Soft fabric. Number one answer was velvet or velour. You said silk. This was 17 points. You have $10,000. Survey said.
Thank you.
Florida was the favorite vacation state. What's your name?
Elizabeth.
You're absolutely gorgeous. We grew these for you.
Thank you.
Thank you. I think she likes me. $10,465. The Ross of Alabama did it. We'll see you here on the Feud. Bye-bye.
It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Dayen family. Jim, Gina, Jonelle, Laurie, and Jill, ready for action. And the Dimes family. Deborah, Richard Jr., Jonathan, Margaret, and Richard. On your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud,
thank you. Okay, marvelous thing I just heard. So, you know the little boy, Gary Coleman, the boy in Different Strokes? He's so great. He's got a big, big movie coming up. He's going to play the undefeated contender in Rocky IX. We have about $10,000 to give away. Dayen's won it.
Yeah! Yeah, you do.
How you doing, Richard?
Who you got here, Jim? Let's meet everybody.
Okay. Well, I'd like to introduce you my, four tag-alongs here. No. My sister, Gina.
Hello, darling.
She was a tomboy. Jonelle's a singer.
Turned out very well.
Hello, hi, Richard.
Jonelle.
And Laurie.
Hello,
she
Laurie.
She took me under her wing. And that's Jill. She's
hello,
my
Richard.
Sweet little baby sister.
We're delighted you're all here. You're a
beautiful
sister, thanks. Yeah. Are you married?
No, sir.
No. Do you have a girlfriend?
No, sir. Well.
I mean, but nobody really serious.
No, sir.
What do you do, Jim?
I'm a firefighter for the city of Los Angeles.
Really?
Yes.
What do we got here, Chief?
I got something for you. It's thought I'd be original and give you something to cover up all your T-shirts with. It's a sweatshirt.
Oh, I love it. Isn't that neat? Yay!
Yeah!
Thank you. I like that one.
You're welcome.
Yeah. If I'm on fire, he'll come and put me out.
Right.
Or if I'm ever with any of his sisters, he'll put me out. Either way, I can't win. But we brought him in from New England. Make him feel at home. The Dimes.
Thank you, Richard.
Who you got here, darling?
Richard, I brought my brother, my older brother, Ricky.
Hello, Richard.
Richard.
Nice to meet you.
My younger brother, Jonathan.
Jonathan.
Nice to meet you, Richard.
My mother, Margaret.
Hi,
mother,
Richard.
Mother, Margaret.
And I brought my father, Richard.
Hi, Richard.
Good to see you, Richard. Welcome.
Welcome.
You're surrounded by Richard here.
Yes,
huh?
Yes.
Where in New England are you?
We're right outside of Boston, about 10 miles, in a town called Winthrop.
Pretty
right
there?
By the airport. Yes, I think so,
but if
yeah.
It's by the airport, it might be a little
it's
noisy.
It's kind of noisy, yes, yeah.
Is the airport always there?
It was, you know, I've been alive, but my father remembers it as an island, and he used to row out and sail to it, and it was really nice. Used to picnic out there.
Then I have, built the airport.
Yeah,
yeah, that's right. Yes. What is this, my darling?
Oh, Richard, we brought you a T-shirt.
Yeah.
From
these
Boston.
But these are thicker. I like these. These are.
And on the back, we inscribed what Boston thinks of you.
Okay.
And what we all think of you.
Here we go. This is very sweet. I'll have to get someone else to wear it.
All right.
Yay!
Thank you.
Thank you, Richard.
Thank you. Come on, we're going to play the Feud. Hundred people survey, top five answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name the part of your body that requires the most maintenance.
Good. Your mouth.
Your mouth.
Good answer.
Okay. Three answers will beat it. Deborah?
Okay.
The part of your body that requires the most maintenance.
Your
Okay, your hands.
Your hands. Okay, you got it by 1 point. What are you going to do, play a pass?
I think we'll play, Richard.
You're going to play, my darling.
Okay, let's go.
I get to meet all your sisters.
Yeah.
Hello. Nice to have you here.
Nice to be here.
Art of your body that requires the most maintenance.
Your hair, Richard.
What?
Your hair.
Hair.
Okay. Good answer. Yeah,
all right.
You say what? I'll say what. Your hair. What would you say, Jenna?
I would say your face.
Good answer.
Face. These girls are coming to pieces right in front of my eyes. What happened, honey?
I don't know. I guess I got too excited. I'm falling
not
apart.
Not at all. Not at all. I'm glad to see you're happy. Hello.
Hello, Richard.
What would you say, lover?
I'm going to say, how about your feet?
Good answer!
Let's, there you have it all without a strike. Feet? No. Oh, that was a good answer.
Good answer,
Lauren. Welcome.
Thank you. I'd say your eyes.
Right.
Okay.
It was there for Jill. You got it all. If not, second strike. Your eyes. No. Jim, polish this off for me.
Okay.
Part of your body that requires the most maintenance.
I'm going to have to say your stomach.
Okay. That's there. You got it. If not, Don, get ready to steal. Your tummy. Nothing. Let's go.
Thank you, Richard.
100 people survey, top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something you've had installed in your house. Yeah.
Refrigerator.
Okay.
All right.
You'll give me the name of the person later. Refrigerator? No.
Burglar alarm, Richard.
Burglar alarm.
Good answer.
Wow, that's amazing. Is your now?
How about wiring? Electricity.
Going where, darling? Where would the wires go?
In the walls of your house.
You can't beat that. Can you, really? Can you send a man over and put some wires in my wall, please? Where do you want it to go? Just in the house. I don't want it outside. Could be dangerous. Wires in the wall. No. Jonathan.
A swimming pool, Richard.
Swimming pool, all right.
Good answer.
Swimming pool. No. But I'm determined to get to the bottom of this.
Maybe I better
Laurie,
ask what the
something
question
you've
was.
Had installed in your house, Laurie.
Okay, how about a smoke detector?
Thank you, darling. Good we'll answer. Take a look. A smoke detector. What? Yeah. Yeah. Try and hold the excitement. Mama, what would you say?
I'd say a new furnace.
All right, a new furnace. No, you've got control of it after 6 attempts. How are you going to play or pass, Dean?
Pass, pass, pass.
We're gonna pass, Richard.
Tell him not to get testy. All right,
go, go.
Nice. Well, I didn't get to see you tonight, Mother Margaret.
Thank you.
Nice to have you with us.
Nice to be here, Richard.
Hey, Poppy, how you doing?
I'm good, Richard.
Something you've had installed in your house?
Kitchen cabinets.
All right, let's take a look. Cabinet. No. Remember, there's $8 at stake, so let's Well.
Air conditioning, Richard.
Air conditioning.
New bathroom, Richard.
New bathroom?
Yes.
All right. A new bathroom. Not that. Jonathan.
Richard, I'd have to say plumbing.
Is there okay? If not, I want to get over this question. Now, plumbing. No. $30 up there.
Oh, okay. All right.
Telephone. 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 Telephone.
Welter.
Telephone.
Yeah.
Telephone.
I mean, that's got to be a number one answer, isn't it? Yeah, it's there, you get it. If not, darling, you get the $30. Telephone!
All right.
Great. Four.
Dishwasher.
I thought, like, cable TV would have been up there. What a horrible thought. We'll be back right after this. $119? Nothing. Let's go. People surveyed. Top five answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something that's cheaper if it's smaller.
A car.
A car.
We're going to pass.
Yeah.
Okay, it's all right with me, Don. Okay. Yeah.
Come on.
I wish Rod Serling were alive to see this. See there, look, the Twilight Zone is actually on the air. You want to play? Yeah. We'll pass. I don't know what it's coming to. My darling, sweet, sweet, sweet Margaret. What's cheaper if it's smaller?
Smaller. Clothing.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You wouldn't pay as much for a little.
No.
Take a look. Clothing. That's amazing.
Oh, what's going on here?
What do you do, by the way, Richard? What's your job?
I'm a sales engineer, selling steel for the building industry.
How long have you been doing that?
Oh, I hate to tell you. 35 years.
Really?
Yeah. You're
going to retire soon?
Oh, about 10 more years.
10 more?
All right.
Something that's cheaper if it's smaller.
Boat.
Boat. Let's take a look. A boat for Richard.
Can't believe it.
That's not a dumb answer at all. It was a goodie, but it didn't make our survey.
Richard, I would say a house.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. Yeah. Very good job.
We'd love a house, please.
How about tents, Richard?
Tents.
A
lovely family, but a weird. A weird family. Yeah, tents. A big tent. No, I'll tell you, it's not such a dumb answer. Let me explain why. I was with the Ringling Brothers Circus. Now, when we buy those big tents, they cost $80 or $90. I'm talking about the big tent. Now, your little tents that the people who sell steel buy, a couple of dollars. So it's not such a bad answer. And it's not such a good answer. Tent! No.
All right.
Well.
Diamond. Television.
What's your answer?
A diamond.
Diamond. You have all the money if it's there, and if not, Deborah and the family get the $48. A diamond. $167, nothing. Let's go. It was lucky I had my Ringling Brothers. Sort of help Richard out there. Dollar values are double. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers are on the board. Here's the question. Name something besides a haircut that men get in a barbershop.
Yeah. A shave.
A shave.
Yeah.
We're
going to
play, Richard.
Okay.
Mm,
thank you.
I like your style. You don't ask anybody, do you? Well, the other way confuses you. How are you?
Oh, okay. How are you?
I love your little headband.
Oh, thank you.
Very sweet.
Thank you.
Well, what do you do, my honey?
Well, I used to work, but I quit. So I just go to school.
Going to school now?
Uh-huh.
Where?
At Milliken High School.
What work did you do?
What work did I do?
I asked you first.
I was a hostess at a restaurant.
What happened? Did they catch you going out with some donuts? Or?
No, I quit. I didn't get fired.
You didn't? Get a lot of tips?
No way.
No tips?
No, when the host is singing, you don't make tips unless you serve beer and wine, which I couldn't do. But
why,
I'm not 18.
Young?
Yeah. I'm
you're not
16.
18?
16.
Well, you should be in school anyway. Huh?
Right.
Yeah. If you want to be a hostess, you come to my place.
Okay.
Do you
pay more than minimum?
I certainly do.
Okay, I'll be there.
Someone like you, I'd pay the maximum. And Social Security. Not many people do that. I'd be delighted to have you there.
Okay.
It's not a large place, but I think we'll be happy there. Something besides a haircut that men get in a barber shop.
How about their sideburns trimmed?
Well, that'd be a haircut.
How about if their fingernails clipped?
Yeah.
I don't know.
They have their fingernails clipped. Very good. In a barber shop besides a haircut, what do men get?
Sometimes they get a massage.
Yeah. Massage. Well, you can. It didn't make those answers, that's all. Looks like pretty Gina.
Thank you. Handsome Richard. I'll say they get their shoe shined or cleaned or whatever.
Shoe shine.
Well done. Okay, Richard, I'm going to say a pedicure.
Good answer,
Jill.
Okay.
Okay.
You know the toes? Yeah.
I know what it is, honey.
Okay.
They whip the shoes off while they're polishing them. Pedicure.
Right.
Gotcha. Well, they don't whip the toes off as well. They take the shoes off. Someone explained there. They take the toes and... There, you got it all. You play with the big money. If not, second strike. Pedicure? No.
Sorry.
Okay.
What do men get in a barbershop besides a haircut?
How about their hair washed?
I like
good
it, honey.
Good answer.
You'd be the champs if you're there, if not there, Shag. Washing of the hair. How cool. Well, but... You know, these people came all the way from New England.
We had a good time, Richard.
We're going to put $100 up there. That'll...
Thank you, Richard.
Thank you, Richard.
Did you really?
We've already had it. This has been worth everything.
We have nice prizes for you. Once you have a safe journey when you go home.
We will.
And thank you for visiting.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Going for the money right after we watch this. Okay, we wish you luck, champ. Get on in.
Thank you very much.
Step in there. $10,000. We'd love you to have it. 15 seconds, please. Tell me how many times a week you really exercise.
3.
A slang word for money.
Cash.
The spice you use most.
Salt.
A magazine that people collect.
Pass.
A large animal man has tamed.
An elephant.
Okay, magazine. All right, turn around. Here we go. How many times a week you really exercise? You said 3. Survey said? 14. Slang word for money. Cash. Survey. 6. Spice you use most? Salt. Survey said? Magazine that people collect, you passed on it. Large animal man has tamed an elephant. Survey said. Not a bad comeback, champ. Off you go. Right over there. Looking for Gina. You can do it, Angel. You know we wish you luck, okay?
Okay.
Please remind everyone the answer Jim gave us. 20 seconds on the clock. Good luck, Donald.
Thank you.
Tell me, how many times a week you really exercise?
3 times a week.
Try again.
Twice a week.
A slang word for money.
Cash.
Try again.
Moolah.
The spice you use most.
Oregano.
A magazine the people collect.
People.
A large animal man has tamed.
A lion.
Okay, turn around. How many times a week do you really exercise? You said two. Survey said 24. Number one answer was once a week.
Oh, wow.
Slang word for money. Dough was number one. You said moolah. Survey said
zero.
Eight. Spice you use most. Salt was number one. Oregano. You said.
That's
survey
right.
said five. Magazine the people collect. You said people. Survey said.
Number one.
National Geographic, number
oh,
one.
Yeah.
I've got about four of them.
I have none.
A large animal that man has tamed. Elephant was number one. You said lion. Survey said 27. 161, $5 every point. Total out.
All right.
$805. We will return. $1,172. That's the good news. The bad news is, because there's so many here, it's about $2 each. We'll see you on the feud. Bye-bye.
It's time for the Family Feud, introducing the Evans family. Travis, Catherine, Eileen, Susie, and Jan, ready for action. And the Carlsen family. Ricky, Cindy, Daryl, Pam, and Virginia. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Listen, we've got two nice families. We've got $10,000, and the Evans want the money. Let's make it easier.
Hello,
you, Travis.
Hello,
good to see you, sir.
Nice to know you, sir.
Can I meet your family, please?
Surely. This is my wife of 40 years, Catherine.
Hello, Catherine.
Hello.
And my oldest daughter, Eileen.
Hi,
hello,
Richard.
Eileen.
Our next youngest daughter is Susie.
Hello, Susie, Richard. Welcome.
And the third daughter is Jan, and we have another one hidden out there somewhere.
I'll find her if it's the last thing I do. Make them feel at home. Is it Karen?
Karen.
No boys in the family?
We also have four sons.
Catherine, what's going on here? Are you a fisherman?
Yes, sir. See that hook? I'm also a king's kid.
Oh, but now, are you commercial fisherman?
Yes, sir.
What do you go out to and catch? Tuna?
We do at times of the year, and bottle fish at the rest of the time. We have a market, children. That's why we're sort of a family.
Now, how long would you go out when you go out to get a, what do they call it, a crop of, school, isn't it a school of fish, is that right?
A school, a catch.
A catch. How long would that take you?
We fish daily for the fresh fish market.
Right.
And when we fish for the canneries, we are fishing as long as 90 days on a trip.
90 days?
Had two of my grandsons out one time for 42 days.
Did you really? How old were they, the little rascals?
11 and 12, about that.
What an adventure that's got to be. Now, what is this here?
This is something we brought for you for, it's rather unique. It was dragged up from the ocean floor. It's a piece of coral with some barnacle steel growing on it, and it sits nice on a mantle, and we thought it would be
look
different.
At that. Isn't that neat? Look how pretty that is. I might wear this in my hair for the Emmy. Wouldn't make me look too show busy, would it? Huh. You mentioned Mobile, didn't you?
Yeah.
These rascals are from Mobile. Right. We brought them in, the Carlsen, right, Ip? When did we get you in? Yesterday?
Yesterday. Yeah. Yes, sir.
All righty. Let's meet everybody, please.
This is my wife, Cindy.
Hello, Richard.
Hello, Cindy.
My Uncle Daryl.
Hello, Richard.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Uncle Daryl.
My sister, Pam.
Hello, Hi. Pam.
And my mother, Virginia.
Good to have you here, darling.
Hi, Richard.
What is this? This is a collector's item. We're from Alabama.
Yeah.
And this is the winningest coach of all time. It's made up in honor of him.
Paul Bear Bryant. I've heard of him.
Hi.
Yeah. Look at that. They make up... Boy, no, we've never had Tommy Lasorda on a bottle here. We did have him on a pastrami sandwich once, didn't we? Hey, thank you. I'll treasure that. Watch him on the tune. Ready to play?
Yes, sir.
Come on, we're going to play the feud. Let's go. He is the winningest coach, isn't he? Remember, 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. You've got to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name a career that women go into more often than men do.
Secretary.
Secretary? Very good. Travis, one answer will beat that.
Beauty salon.
Beauty? Beauty salon, is that what you said? Beauty salon. It's there, but you got control. What are you going to do?
We're going to play, Richard.
We're going to play, champ. All right. Very good, Rick. Very proud of you. Hello.
Hello.
How you doing?
Just fine.
Career that women go into more often than men.
What about a nurse?
Let's look. Nurse!
Good answer. Good answer.
Yeah.
What a way to start the game. How you doing, Uncle Richard? Darrell?
Great.
You look very young to be an uncle.
I am.
What do you say here?
I say stewardess.
All right.
Oh,
stewardess. Not there. Hello, honey.
Hi.
Nice to have you with us.
Thank you.
Career that women go into more often.
I'll say waitressing.
All righty, let's look.
Good answer.
Waitress! No. How are you, Virginia? How are you doing?
Fine.
You look good.
Thank you.
Not nervous, are you?
Mm-hmm. Very.
Come on, you're going to be fine. You're going to be a star. Career that women go into more often than men do.
Dress designer.
Good answer.
I like that, darling. If that's there, Virginia, you're okay. If not, clear your strike. Dress designer. Well, darling, it still was a good answer. Come on up here, Travis. Get all your ladies together and give me an answer.
Teacher.
Or model.
What do you say?
Teacher, Dad.
Teacher, they said.
All right. Is that the one you say?
Well, I wouldn't say that, but I better do what the girls say.
You're right, Dad.
So that's your that's your answer, teacher?
Teacher.
Okay. He's so sweet. Teacher's there, Travis. You get the $78. If not, you do, Ricky. Teacher?
Yeah!
And five? Six? 78? Nothing? Let's go. Come on. Welcome, Captain.
Thank you.
Nice to have you here. Travis, you were pretty smart listening to the ladies. 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something people open in the morning and close at night. Yeah.
The refrigerator.
The refrigerator. Well, that's how all the food gets spoiled, you say. Catherine, there's something people open in the morning and close at night.
Windows.
The windows.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Are you going to play or pass? They're going to play, okay?
Okay.
I like the refrigerator. It made me smile. Hello.
Hi, Richard.
I was quite proud of Dad the way he took all your advice.
Me too. I thought he did a good job.
Yeah. Although you also said model as well as teacher, uh-huh. And that was up there. Something people open in the morning and close at night.
I'm going to say drapes or curtains.
Okay. The drapes. How are you?
I'm fine.
You got a nice
a
answer
nervous.
For me?
No, not a real nice answer,
oh,
but maybe
on.
Door is up there.
Door?
Maybe.
All right, let's look. Door!
Oh,
door. Why did you not think that was a good answer? People do that, don't they? Hello.
Hi.
What do people open in the morning, close at night?
Well, I work, and I work in our fish market, and I open, and I make sure it's closed at night. So I'll say my business or a business.
Okay,
good.
My doll.
Oh, God.
All right, the business.
They're sharp. I wish I could listen to them right now. They've got me over a bit.
Oh, you're fine now. Something people open in the morning and close at night, Travis.
Shower.
Good answer, Dad. Good answer, Dad.
Thank you for your
Your water bills must be very, very high at the end of the month. I want you to switch it off after every shower. Promise me you'll do that. Shower? No. That's the same as the refrigerator there. You can't just switch it on. What would you think, my darling? Something that people open in the morning, close at night. You're a cutie pie with it. What?
The air conditioning or the heater.
Okay.
Air conditioning.
We'll take a look. Air conditioning? No.
All right. Okay.
We're early in the game yet. Something people open in the morning, close at night.
You're not going to believe this answer, but their eyes...
I do not know if it's there, but I would have thought that that was the number one answer. But it didn't turn out to be number one. I thought that would be the number one answer.
I agree.
Let's hope it's up there.
Yes.
Is there okay if not their star? Their eyes! Very good, very good. Pretty soon, Dave.
Not doing too well.
Well, you gave me an answer the last time it was up there.
Mm-hmm.
3 seconds.
How about a mailbox?
Mailbox? Yeah. All right.
Good answer.
I think a fair answer.
Fair answer.
Yeah. Is there okay?
Try.
If not, third strike. Ricky, get ready to steal. Mailbox! No. $87 up there.
School.
Something
school.
People open in the morning and close at night.
Richard, we're going to say school.
School, already. School is there, sir. You get the $87. If not, Travis, a big lead. School. Number four. See, I never would have thought of that because the drapes and curtains were already up there. Anyway, I don't even have windows at home. We're very poor. I'll be back right after that. Yeah. 165, still nothing here. Let's go! First family to 300, place for $10,000. 100 people surveyed, top 7 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a yellow food.
Yeah. Banana.
Banana. One answer. Uncle Darryl, you beat it.
Butter.
Butter. It's there, but they have control. What are you going to do?
We're going to play, Richard.
Very proud of you.
How about a yellow cake?
Okay.
Good answer. Good.
Could have just said cake, and then I would have assumed it had been yellow. No, because a black cake would not fall under this category.
No.
Cake! Oh, not there. Very, very heavy finger on that buzzer. I'd like a little more genteelness, if I may.
I wanted to tell you,
what?
My father-in-law, my husband, and my son are all named Richard.
Are they really? That's sweet. Where are they here?
My father-in-law's here. My husband had to work. And my son is someplace here, I think.
Well, he'll be here somewhere.
Derek.
We'll find Richards, and we'll bring them to you. Who's that other little cutie pie right next to you?
Hey, this is Christy. And that's...
Who is it?
That's my little fisherman.
What's it?
Christy.
Hello, sweetheart.
Waves to everybody. Ah, look at that. What an album cover. She's beautiful. All right, enough of this. I know, just hit me. A yellow food.
Corn.
Good answer, Alan Corn. Yellow food, Travis.
Mustard.
Mustard, please. Not there. Second strike.
Second.
It is yellow, just didn't make our survey. What would you say, Kim?
Lemon.
Lemon. Lemon? Yellow food.
Squash?
Let's look. Is there all right? If not, third strike, squash. What do you say, Zay?
Okay, me again.
Right.
All right.
Yellow food.
Oh, boy.
3 seconds. Sounds like a fuel marshal. Chance for you to get $83 and get in the game. Oop. Good Lord alive. Your heel got caught in the draft.
What do you say?
Wax yellow rice.
Rice.
Yellow rice.
Egg yolk.
Egg yolk.
Yellow food.
You're going to say yellow rice.
Yellow rice. If it's there, you get it. If not, a big lead for you. Rice! Four. Seven. That was the other answer I heard. All right, 248, nothing. Let's go. Dollar values are doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers on the board. Here's the question. Tell me something overweight people do to make themselves appear slimmer. Yes.
They wear dark clothes.
They wear dark clothes.
Gonna
play?
Yes.
Nice way to treat people from Mobile, aren't they? They do it all here. All righty, here we go. What do overweight people do to make themselves appear slimmer?
Wear tall shoes.
Okay. Carry a big stick. Wear tall shoes. Not that. Very interesting theory, though, Jan. What do you say, Travis?
Their foundation garments, girdles. And
gotcha,
garments.
Gotcha. Girdle. Something overweight people do to make themselves appear slimmer.
Wear stripes.
Wear stripes. All righty, darling. Stripes. That's why you never see a fat convict. You don't. That's technically well known.
I'm going to say that you wear one piece. You don't break it up with lots of
all righty, my love.
You wear one piece. You wear one dress or one suit.
All righty, fine. That's there, my darling. Okay, if not, second strike. One piece. No. Susie, what do overweight people do to make themselves appear slimmer?
How about hide behind a coat, under a coat?
Hide behind a coat?
Okay. Loose.
Hide under or near a coat. Not only is there no money up there, you probably tore your dress, Virginia, didn't you?
No.
Well, your heel got caught, didn't I see?
On the hem.
Going to give you an extra $100 to get that dress fixed. I'm a bit embarrassed about that. You got nice prizes. Have a nice flight home, okay? I'm sorry you didn't win. But I'm on a route to your team. Thank you. Thank you. Sorry about your dress. Full play. Come on. I need two people. One, who's first? $10,000 right after we watch this. Excuse me being tardy. I had to sew that hem up.
I thought you weren't going to show. I was nervous.
Oh, no. I just did Virginia's hem. Good luck.
Thanks.
15 seconds, please. Name the kind of flower that lasts the longest before wilting.
Carnation.
An expensive breed of dog.
Doberman.
Something on a soldier's uniform.
badge or emblem.
The months with the best weather.
September.
A sport with screaming fans.
Football.
Turn around. Kind of far, the last launch before wilting, you said? Carnation. Survey said? An expensive breed of dog, a Doberman. Survey. Six. Something on a soldier's uniform. You said? Emblem. Survey said? 14. The month with the best weather. September. Survey. 3. Sport with screaming fans. Football. Survey said? I like that. That's very good. Off you go. Sweet Tuesday. Hey, hey. Listen. All you need is 85 points and you have $10,000. Oh. Wish you luck. Please remind everyone the answers Jan gave us. 20 seconds on the clock, please. Tell me the kind of flower that lasts the longest before wilting.
A rose.
An expensive breed of dog.
Doberman.
Try again.
Fox terrier.
Something on a soldier's uniform.
Stripes.
The month with the best weather.
June.
A sport with screaming fans.
Hockey.
Okay, turn around. Kind of flower lasts longest before wilting. Carnation was number one. You said rose. Survey said 18. An expensive breed of dog. Poodle was the number one answer. You said fox terrier. Survey said they're giving those away now. Something on a soldier's uniform. You said stripes. Survey said 14. Number one answer, medals. Medals. And then the month with the best weather. You said June. It was number one. Survey said 33. The sport was screaming fans. Football was number one. You said hockey. If it's worth 20 points, you got $10,000. Survey said 195 dollars every point. Total of 950. We will return. If we could wait, darling, but we've got David Horowitz coming on. I want you to share the... I want you to promise the missing Richard will get one of those. Look at this, a cutie pie. $1,380. We'll see you here on the Feud. Bye-bye.
Let's meet the McHan family. Joe, Debbie, Shirley, Donna, and Bob. Ready for action. Playing against the Raymond family. Petey, Gina, Stan, Kelly, and Jelly. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Thank you for tuning in, and if you just joined us, you know that today we're looking for brand new champions on Family Feud. And still, before February, we have our Tournament of Champions, where the winner will take a potential jackpot of over $100,000, a potential jackpot of $100,000. The two families who are playing today can still win enough money to make them be in that tournament. They are here today for the first time. I want you to welcome the McCann family.
Hey, how you doing, Ray?
Doing fine, Joe.
Good.
I detect a little bit of an accent. Where's your family from?
We're from San Diego, California, sir.
San Diego, originally from there? Born and raised?
No, sir, originally from Maryland.
All right, so you moved out here.
Yes.
Who'd you bring with you from San Diego?
Ray, I got my lovely wife, Debbie.
Hello, lovely Debbie.
Hi.
My brother-in-law, Bobby.
Hello, right. Bobby.
My sister-in-law, Donna.
Hi, Donna.
Hi.
And my favorite mother-in-law, Shirley.
Your favorite mother-in-law. Good way to put it. You're in pursuit of being the champions and playing for $10,000. And there's a family that's waited a long time to be on Family Feud. And they want to beat you. They are the Raymond family.
Yay! Yay! Oh, Sam, how are you?
Good.
You're fine, you're fine.
I'm doing fine.
Lovely, lovely women. Who are these women?
Well, these women are all my women.
These are your women? All right, Stan, the man.
First off, we have my...
Who did you bring with you?
I brought my lovely wife, Gina.
That's your wife.
I brought my mother-in-law, Petey.
Okay. Hello, Petey,
hi. How are you?
I brought my zany sister-in-law, Kelly.
Hi, Kelly.
Hi, Ray.
And I brought my favorite cousin, Jelly.
Hey.
Jelly?
Yeah.
Jelly, Kelly,
Petey,
and Gina. All right, Stan, these are your women. I'll remember that as we play The Feud. Come on, the first family with $300 will win the game and get a chance to play Fast Money for $10,000 and will be the new champion. So good luck to both. We ask 100 people this question. We put the top five answers on that board. Try to find the most popular answer to this question. Tell me something specific a man might put in his wallet to hide from his wife. Stan.
Money.
He says you hide money from your wife. Number two, extra money, Joe. One answer gives you control. Something specific a man might put in his wallet to hide from his wife.
A credit card.
Could it be? A credit card. Not there. McCann family from Tennessee. Gina, where's your family from?
From Los Angeles.
Right here in Los Angeles? Yes. Okay, what do you say?
I say another woman's telephone number.
Whoa! A man would hide another woman's telephone number in his wallet? Let me see another woman's telephone number. It is number one. 50 people said it. Gina, that's... It might be more than coincidence that you know that. You ever caught Stan?
No.
You've got four women here today.
No, no. He would not be here.
If you caught him. Does that mean because you wouldn't be with him or he wouldn't be alive?
Because he wouldn't be alive.
All right. Stan, keep that in mind. Okay. Okay, Gina. Petey, what a smile you have.
Thank you.
It's contagious. I'm looking at you. I'm going like, serious.
I'm happy to be here today.
Well, we're happy to have you.
Thank you.
You played at home and played along?
Well, I watch a lot.
Okay, let's see how you do. It's different here. You'll see. We've got three answers on the board. What would one of them be?
I'd say a check stub.
A man would hide a check stub from his wife in his wallet?
Yes.
Show me a check stub. It's only one strike. I'm sorry, Petey. Kelly.
Hi, Ray.
How you doing?
Hi, how are you?
And these smiles are going around.
Thank you.
I'm doing good. Question is to tell me something that a man specifically would hide in his wallet from his wife.
What about the auto teller receipts?
I can tell you've hidden a few of those. You have a man? Are you married?
Good. No, I'm not.
A boyfriend? She's not answering. I can tell she's not committing herself. She says the auto teller receipts from the bank. There's number three. Nine people said it. Jelly.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm great. Now, except she took my answer.
Well, there's two more up there. What flavor of jelly are you?
Chocolate?
Chocolate jelly? More like a jam.
Okay.
Something specific a man might put in his wallet to hide from his wife? Well, Jelly, is that your God-given name?
No, this is my nickname.
And your real name is?
Deborah Angelique.
Deborah Angelique. Okay, Deborah Angelique. Jelly?
Yes.
What do you say the answer would be? Something a man would hide from his wife in his wallet?
Oh, I'll have to say checkbook.
He'd hide his checkbook in his wallet. Show me his checkbook. The last two answers may not be that easy. Stan, what do you say? The McCann's looking to steal. What do you say?
I'd say key.
He'd hide a key. Two?
Safe deposit box.
Key to a safe deposit box. Maybe a man would hide a key. It's not there. They have to steal it. $84 up for grabs. Help the head of the family with one answer. Tell me something specific a man might put in his wallet to hide from his wife. Shirley?
Oh, I can't.
That's okay. Donna? Nothing?
A picture?
Address?
Picture, yes. Address. Joe, there's two answers.
Ray, I'm going to go with a picture of an old girlfriend or friend.
That picture, that pee when you said it, burst of air hit me in the eyes and blinded me.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Picture of an old girlfriend. You got $84 if we see a picture. Yeah! Picture of an old girlfriend. Joe was right as you said it. Money comes in the McCann family. We did not know. Number four. We're coming right back. If you have extra kids, women, you might know why. Look in your husband's wallet. We're coming back. Don't go away. Ho!
In a wallet?
Welcome back to the Cube. We're looking for new champions. The McHan family has $84, leading the Raymond family, who has zero as we go. With another face-off, Debbie. Here comes the team. You beautiful girls. We put the top four answers on the board. Listen carefully to this question. Name something that's white and expensive. Gina?
A mink coat.
Show me.
A mink coat.
Number one, first story. McCann stole it last. All right, Petey, there's three answers left. She gave number one, something that's white and expensive. What a laugh.
An illegal
what?
Cocaine.
Okay, well, that it could be up there. It is white, it is expensive, there's been a lot of movies controversial today. Show me cocaine. Not, could have been there. Condom was there last time, and I know you're taking a shot at things.
Too bad condoms aren't white this time. And expensive.
You can buy them white. But the question is something that's white and expensive.
Okay. Well, it's not exactly white, but it's kind of clear. Diamonds.
Diamonds, yeah?
Diamonds.
Maybe.
Maybe.
I don't know what's up there.
Okay.
Show me diamonds. McCann family, keep those thinking caps on.
Oh,
Jelly, they're going for this.
Man.
Oh, man. An old man?
Come on, Jelly, you can do this.
Show me an old white man.
Okay. Give me another question. One more time.
Something that's white and expensive.
I'll say a fur rug.
A white fur rug?
Yeah.
I think we're beating this fur thing to death. Okay. Show me a white fur rug. It's only $34, but they still have to steal it. Come on, McCann. You can make a bigger lead.
White Rolls Royce.
A white Rolls Royce. Donna.
Pearls.
Bengal Tiger.
Bengal?
Pearls,
Rolls Royce, Bengal Tiger, Joe, there's three answers to steal from. What do you say?
I'm going to go with my family, Ray, and stay with Pearls.
If Pearls are not there, they're on the board. Show me Pearls. Yeah! Makes sense. What do you want? You take $34 more. Something that's white and expensive. What was number two? Wedding gown. I heard somebody in the crowd scream it a little late. We're not supposed to scream it anyway. Number four. Car. White Rolls Royce. You would have had them. We are going to come right back, and the Raymond family still want to be the champions. So get the champion. Double the dollar value. You can do it. Next question, we're going to double that dollar value. You can do it, Sarge.
We can do it.
We're coming back. The McCann family, $118, trying to be the champions. The Raymond, zero. We go. Another six. The Raymonds are going to come back. The Raymonds are coming back.
Right now.
We double the dollar value. We put the top six answers on the board. We ask 100 people to name a food you wouldn't or couldn't eat with your fingers. Petey.
Crab.
Show me a crab. It's not there. Bob?
Cake.
Bob says, a food you wouldn't or couldn't eat with your fingers? Cake. Don't say anything, Petey. Keep it to yourself. Come here, Bob. Stay right here. Go over to Kelly. Name a food. Stop touching your nose, Kelly. Stop touching your nose. Name a food you wouldn't or couldn't eat with your finger.
Chinese food.
Show me. Is that specific enough? Okay, show me Chinese food. Come over here to Donna.
Come on, Donna.
Listen carefully. Name a food you wouldn't or couldn't eat with your fingers.
Spaghetti.
Show me spaghetti. You think of a steal. Think of a steal, Raymond family.
Good answer, Donna.
Took a little while to get this question rolling, but Shirley, you're the kind of the mother of this. You got an answer. I can see it.
Soup.
Soup?
Soup.
That's a good answer. Couldn't wait to say it. Let me see. Soup. It's number two. 23 people said it. And between number 34 said number one, 23 said number two. These next four might be a little tough. Joe?
Yes, sir.
I don't know. It started slow. A food you wouldn't or couldn't eat with your fingers.
Ray, I'm going to go with breakfast cereal.
Cereal. Breakfast right. Cereal. Show it to me. Breakfast cereal. And hope for the Raymond family. You're hoping to get the chance to steal, so find that steal. Debbie. What do you say?
I say mashed potatoes and gravy.
The crowd's with you.
Good answer.
You could do it, but it's kind of messy. Show me mashed potatoes and gravy.
All right, Debbie, good answer.
Mashed potatoes.
There you go,
it's your first answer, and it's
Come
there.
On, Bobby.
All right, Bob. We're going right down the line. There's three left. If by chance they get the chance to steal and do it, they'll have the lead instead of you winning. What do you say?
How about a salad?
There's three answers up there. Is one of them a salad? Raymond family, you'll get the chance to steal and have the lead if Donna doesn't tell me a food you couldn't or wouldn't eat with your fingers.
How about rice?
Maybe. You're still alive on this question if we see rice. Raymond family, if you steal it, you've got the lead. If not, they got a bigger one. Name a food you wouldn't or couldn't eat with your fingers. Jelly.
Ice cream.
Ice cream?
Yeah, ice cream.
Ice cream?
Ice cream.
Ice cream. Ice cream. Ice cream. Ice cream. Stand. A food you wouldn't or couldn't eat with your fingers. You got three choices. Your family say ice cream. What do you say?
Ice cream.
Your wife looked at you and she went, ice cream.
What am I going to do?
So you have no choice but to say it. But what would you have said if you hadn't said ice cream?
Ice cream.
It's an ice cream. There's a man that has nothing in his wallet. Okay, show me ice cream. You got it. Number four answer. $140 come your way. What was number five? Pudding or Jell-O? I was thinking of Jelly. Number six. Tea. The lead goes over to the Raymond family. $140. The McCanns, $118 as we go. With another face-off. Come on. Kelly and Don.
Oh, we didn't shake.
Well, nice. Thank you. Well, we didn't shake either, everybody. There you go. Doggone it. The dollar value is tripled as we put the top four answers on the board. We ask 100 people this thought-provoking question. Tell me something people do after you've paid them a compliment. Donna.
Thank you.
Okay. Something people do right after you pay them a compliment, say thank you. Number one. That's it, Kelly. They got control, but you think of a steal. This is a triple-valued question worth a lot of money. Shirley, something that people do right after you've paid them a compliment.
Smile.
They smile. All right. Show me a smile. We've got $189 there. I believe whoever takes this question will win the game. Joe.
Yes, Ray.
Either team can win. What do you say?
I'm ready, Ray.
With?
I'm going to go with shake your hand.
Something people do right after you pay them a compliment is they shake your hand. Let me see. Hand shaking. Hope for your opponents with one strike. Debbie? Oh, half of the survey said thank you. We got two answers left.
Blush.
Yes. Get embarrassed.
Good answer, Debbie. Good answer. Good answer.
You see blushing.
Yeah! Good answer, Bobby.
$282 in the bank,
Bob.
Now, if you can give me number four, you're playing for $10,000. What is number four?
We pay you with another compliment.
They, as soon as you give them a compliment, they give you one.
Good answer, Bobby.
Show me repay you for the game with another compliment. Say goodbye to a wonderful family. Stan, thank you for playing so well.
Gina,
we got nice parting gifts for you. Stay right here. Gina, your smile is so sweet. Kelly, stay right here. Kelly, don't go anywhere. Stay right here, okay? I need two players. $10,000 in the Tan family right now. Who's playing first? You playing first? Bye-bye, Joe, off stage. The McCann playing fast money for $10,000. After this, don't go away. McCann family do have the chance and may still be one of our great top four money-winning families in our Tournament of Champions coming up in February, where the winner will take it all, a potential jackpot of over $100,000. For Donna, there's a lot at stake. Plus, before that, a very special Family Feud. Five great baseball players of today against five umpires who called them out coming up in February. But right now, you want to tune more towards that Tournament of Champions. I'm going to ask you five questions. You have 15 seconds to give me the most popular answers that you can think of. When you and your partner pile up 200 or more points, you get $10,000. Are you ready?
Ready.
15 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, Donna. Time won't begin until I finish reading the first question. Name a sport you can participate in even if you're middle-aged and not in great shape.
Softball.
The age when you first learned the facts of life.
13.
A cheerful color.
Red.
Something that comes in a squeeze container.
Dish detergent.
A popular way to prepare potatoes.
Bake them.
Turn around. That is five. A sport you can participate in even if you're middle-aged and not in great shape. You said softball. What did our survey say? Five people, you're on the board. The age when you first learned the facts of life, you said? The age of 13. Our survey said 15. I asked you a cheerful color, and you said? Color red. Survey said 19. Something that comes in a squeeze container. You said? Squeezing dish detergent. Our survey said 0. A popular way to prepare potatoes, your choice was bake them, our survey said. 31, not bad, 70, very fine. It's 130 points for your brother-in-law, Joe. Come on. It is not bad, Joe. Look straight ahead. You can do this. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, revealing your partner's answers. If you hear this sound, it means you've duplicated her answer, and I'll say try again, bring it home. Name a sport you can participate in, even if you're middle-aged and not in great shape.
Bowling.
The age when you first learned the facts of life.
13.
Try again.
14.
A cheerful color.
Yellow.
Something that comes in a squeeze container.
Fruit dressing.
A popular way to prepare potatoes.
Boiled.
Turn around. We need 130 points. Step right over here close to me. Right there you go, right there. A sport you can participate in, even if you're middle-aged and not in great shape. You said bowling. Our survey said
All right.
Bowling, number one answer tied with golf. The age when you first learned the facts of life, you said 14. Our survey said 11.
All right.
12, the number one answer. Age to learn facts of life, a cheerful color, you said yellow. Survey said Step over this way, just a bit, Joe. It came down to these last two questions. You're 39 points away. Something that comes in a squeeze container. You need a big finish. You said the squeeze container of fruit dressing. Survey said 0. Toothpaste number one. A popular way to prepare potatoes. You said to boil them. If 39 people said boil, you've got $10,000. What did our survey say? 2. Mash number one. $5 a point gives you. $815. Come out here and hug him. The McCanns are still the champions, and we're coming right back. Don't go away. I'm Ray Combs saying thank you for watching. We will see you next time.
Bye-bye. The McCann family. Joe, Debbie, Shirley, Donna, and Bob, ready for action. Playing against the Bridges family. Cynthia, Belda, Elton, Eleanor, and Marilyn. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. Here's the star of Family Feud, Ray Cope.
So we should meet our returning champions. They're here one more time. Will you say hello to the McCann family?
All right, how you doing,
Joe? I'm doing fine.
You look nice today.
Who said I look nice today?
I did.
Thank you, Debbie.
Very nice.
You look nice today, too.
Thank you.
Where's everybody from?
Originally from Maryland, Ray, but right now living in San Diego, California.
All right, Joe. And who did you bring with you?
Ray, I bought my gorgeous wife,
Debbie. You bought her or you brought her?
Brought her.
Okay.
Brought her.
Because if you bought her, that's illegal. What? And who else?
My brother-in-law, Bobby. Hi, Bobby.
How you doing?
My beautiful sister-in-law, Donna.
Hi, Donna.
Hi, Ray.
And my gorgeous mother-in-law, Shirley.
Hi,
Welcome
Ray.
Back to family.
All right. Thank you, Ray.
Your family is trying desperately to get into that tournament of champions. I wish you a lot of luck, but there's a family that come a little ways to defeat you. They're very handsome. We'll see how they play. Will you welcome the Bridges family? Dawson, how are you?
How are you?
It's a pleasure to have your family on the show.
Thank you.
Where are you from?
We're from L.A.
Right here?
Yes.
Who'd you bring to help you dethrone those champions?
Well, I brought my lovely cousins with me, Velda.
Velda?
Cynthia?
Yes.
Eleanor?
Aye.
And Marilyn.
Yay! Welcome to family. Somebody is going to play for $10,000.
Yes.
But to do that, we've got to play The Feud. Let's go, McHan family. Let's go, Bridges family.
Let's go.
The first family to $300 will win the game, get a chance to play fast money for the $10,000. Good luck to both families. Here we go. We asked 100 people this question. We put the top six answers on that board. Try to find the most popular answer to this question. It's a great question, I might add. Name a first that every man remembers. Elton.
Sex.
Show me sex. There it is now. There are five answers that will give you control. Joe, name a first that every man remembers.
Ray, their first kiss.
Okay, show me their first kiss. All right. Now we've got four answers on that board. Name a first that every man remembers.
Their first marriage.
Good answer, Debbie.
That was good.
Debbie, how many times have you been married? Twice. And so you think that your first husband remembers it more than your second. Is that what you're saying? If you'd do a little more kissing and having more sex, that'd have been enough. All right, here we go. Show me the first marriage.
All right, there we go.
I don't know if there's any correlation that seven people said first sex and first wife. I don't know. Maybe that's why you got a second wife. Only seven of them. Bob.
How about his car?
His first car.
Yeah.
Man's first car. Judge said that's the same as first sex. Just kidding. Let me see. First car. Hi, Donna. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Now, just give me one of those answers. Name a first that every man remembers.
How about the first time he shaves?
The first time he shaves. You'll always remember that. Yeah, I'll never forget. I cut my knee. I was going like that. I was watching my mother, you know, as a small boy. Show me the first time you shave. No! Shirley?
Yes.
There's only one strike. She's touching me. So don't be nervous. Name a first that every man remembers.
I say first date.
Their first date. Could it be their first date? Yes. Very nice. Bridges, they're not giving you much of a chance. Joe, stop clapping just for a second. Now, there's one answer on that board. It's the most popular answer in all the survey. You give it to me, it's a clean sweep, and you got a lead. What do you say?
I'm going to say his first day at school, Ray.
First day at school. All right. Bridget, you will get a chance
right,
to
come on, Debbie. I think I got it.
And take the bank. What is it?
Job.
A man will remember his first job. You got the bank. If we see a job. No! Bridget, $1,000 are coming your way if you name a first that every man remembers. Marilyn.
Lover.
A man remembers his first lover.
Girlfriend.
You say name Eleanor? His first girlfriend. Cynthia?
I don't
she
know.
She doesn't know.
First love.
First love?
Yes.
Could also be construed as first lover? No, it could not be. The judge has been ruled. Lovers are not love. All right, Elton?
First love.
First love, first lover?
First
nothing?
Love. First love.
First love. All right. Without putting the words in their mouth, if number one is first love, you've stolen the bank. Show me first love. Bang! You've got the bank. The Bridges family, take up the McHan. We are coming right back. For more great questions, you never know what's going to be on the survey after this. We are back.
Right now, the Bridges have $51. From McHan, zero, we go. Another face off. Let us go. Zelda and Debbie, they shake hands. We've got the top five answers on the board as we ask this question. Name something that is associated with a Southern belle. Zelda.
A mansion.
How about a mansion? It's there. Oh, okay, Zelda, but wait a minute. Debbie, four answers will give you control so that you can go, yeah! Something associated with a Southern belle.
One of the long dresses.
A long dress. Show me a long dress. Fancy dresses. They've got control over the steel. McCann family, they stole your bag once before. Bob, are you going to give them that chance? What do you say? Something associated with a Southern belle.
How about her accent?
Her accent. Amazing. Show me a Southern accent.
Yes.
Number one. $67 in the bank. And Donna, already enough in the bank that you can take the lead if your family takes this question. What do you say?
How about gracefulness?
Gracefulness?
Yeah, babe.
Okay.
They're considered more graceful. Show me a graceful Southern belle. Hope for the Bridges. Now, surely, last question. You saved the family. You came up with a great answer. You can do it again. Name something that is associated with a Southern belle.
Mint julep.
Mint?
Julep.
Mint julep. Ooh. Maybe a mint julep. Did you? You stole the bank just like this before. Joe, you can stop them. You got two answers up there. Something associated with a Southern belle.
Ray, I can picture a Southern belle carrying an umbrella.
An umbrella.
Yes,
sir. An umbrella. To smack Southern men.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Show me an umbrella. Bridges family, this may not be as easy to steal. If you do not, they will take $67. Name something that is associated with a Southern belle.
A kept woman.
A kept woman.
They do it up north, too.
All right.
Eleanor? Good answer.
A good hostess.
A good hostess?
A carriage.
A carriage.
Good answer. A petticoat.
A petticoat? Elton, there's some fine answers there, but you can go out on your own if you
carriage.
Wish. Two answers will get you that back. Kept
woman. We're going to go with a carriage.
A carriage?
Yeah.
All right.
Carriage.
Carriage. Carriage. $67 if we see a carriage. The McCann family, take her back. There's two answers that we did not know. Something that is associated with a Southern belle. Number three. Hat.
I thought a hat.
Hat.
Uh-huh. Thought a hat.
Hat. Who thought of that?
I was thinking that. I was thinking.
But you never said it.
That's
number
right.
Four.
Beauty.
We're coming right back. Anyone can play for $10,000 and we come back. Cynthia, good luck. Bob, good luck. The dollar value is double. The top six answers are on the board to this very important question. Name an occupation in which men have reputations for playing around. Cynthia.
A pimp.
A pimp. Name an occupation in which men have reputations for playing around. You say pimps, okay, it's your move. I got your jacks. Here we go. Show me pimps. Bob, I think you have the chance to take control here. Name an occupation in which men have reputations for playing around. Pimps already said.
How about an actor?
An actor?
Yes.
All right.
Wait a minute.
Did you say pimp or pips? Gladys Knight in the pips.
I said pimp.
You said pimp. All right. Show me an actor. There it is. TV or movie star. Oh, Cynthia, you're going to love that when you see it. See yourself. All right. All right, Bob, you started that. All right, Donna, here we go. Name an occupation in which men have reputations for playing around.
Businessmen.
Businessmen. Is that specific
Donna,
enough?
Like...
Okay, show me. Businessmen. Now, wait a minute. Judge. Judge, what is a pimp? I think we'll have to take this one to court. All right, Shirley? An occupation in which men have reputations for playing around.
How about a sports figure?
A sports figure?
Like in football?
Like, okay. She says, a sports figure. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, Joe, the number one answer's up there. We're looking for an occupation in which men have reputations for playing around.
Ray, I think I have the number one answer. How about gynecologist?
Show me a gynecologist.
All right.
You know what? I take it back. I take it back because when my wife got a breast exam the other day and she went to the dentist, I knew they were out of line.
Okay. All right, Debbie. Come on, Debbie. Come on, Debbie.
Two answers are there. An occupation in which men have reputations for playing around. What do you think?
I think I have the number one.
What is it?
Politician.
Oh, politician! Okay. It's about time we get sex back where it belongs. Show me politics. Yeah.
You don't have the number one answer.
Oh, what
do
you say?
Come on, Bobby.
I don't like the curse, but it is a damn shame that the politicians are ahead of the pimps in this survey. That's all. There's one answer there, and I'm afraid what it could be, Bob. An occupation which men have reputations for playing around. What is it? Or the bank.
How about a bartender?
How about a bartender? Show me a bartender. No. Bridges family. I knew it was only one strike. But if I don't do this from time to time, the staff is never put to the test to see if they're paying attention. Donna, name an occupation which men have reputations for playing around.
The only thing I can think of is airline pilot.
An airline pilot? Maybe. Show me an airline pilot. Now, surely, think about this. There are two strikes. The number one answer is up there. It might be something that you wouldn't think, but it is the most popular answer. An occupation in which men have a reputation for playing around. What might that be today?
I'm going to say a lawyer.
A lawyer. Show me, to stay alive, a lawyer. Not there. One answer. Marilyn? I don't know the answers, but I think I know number one. Occupation in which men have reputations for playing around, Maryland.
Policeman.
Yes!
Policeman? Eleanor?
Salesman.
Salesman, Cynthia?
Professor.
Professor?
Policeman.
Policeman?
Policeman.
Elton?
Policeman.
Elton?
Policeman.
Now listen to me, there is only one answer that can get you this bank. It is the most popular answer in the survey. You give it to me, you've got a big lead. If not, the McCanns do. You can go out on your own. What do you say?
Policeman!
You don't have to take their answer. What were you
going to go out on a limb.
Go out on a limb and say?
Minister.
Ministers is what you say. That is thinking. Used to be a time if you wanted to get a girl, you get in a band. Now you get a church. Okay. All right. Show me, and I hope it's not there. It's a sad commentary if we see a minister. No, the McHale has the back. What is? Number one. Said by Alan. We've got $179 for the McCann family. The bridge is 51. We go with another baseball. Let us go. Donna, come on. Here we go, Alan. The dollar value will be tripled. The top five answers are on the board. Name a specific food that comes with different toppings. Alan.
A sundae.
Let me see a sundae. Numero uno. You tripled Maryland, a specific food that comes with different toppings.
Yogurt.
Let me see. Yogurt. No. This is a big bank. What do you say, Elton? A specific food that comes with different toppings.
Salad.
How about salad? Bam. There is enough money.
Baked potatoes.
Zelda says a baked potato. Yeah. Bam. $175. We continue to grow. Cynthia.
I can't.
Take a guess. A specific food that comes with a different topping.
Bread.
Bread. Show me the popular bread. They're going to try to steal. They'll win the game if they do. Eleanor, what do you say?
Pizza.
Yeah! Who did he? Stay alive pizza. Bam! If you give me number three, Marilyn, you will win the game, become the champions, play for $10,000. If not, they're going for the steal. What's the answer?
Spaghetti!
Show me! Yay! For the game! Spaghetti!
No! McCann, if you don't give me number three, they're playing for $10,000. Specific food that comes with different toppings.
Cake. Shirley.
Cake. Donna.
Burger.
Burger.
Bob. Burger, that was mine.
Hot dog.
Hot dogs, burgers, burger, and cakes. Burger, Joe, burger, with them or out on your own. Burger, if you don't give me number three, they're playing for 10,000 big
Let's
ones.
Let's go with the good old American hamburger.
You're playing for $10,000 if we see the burger! Yay! They maintain. We did not know number three. Kate, who said that?
Shirley said it.
Goodbye. Let me say goodbye to this.
Thank you very much, guys.
We have over $1,400. You made it very special. Stay right here. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you. We enjoyed it.
I need two players for $10,000. Who's playing right now? Who's playing first? Zelda with me. Bye-bye, Element. The Bridges play. Fast money for $10,000 right after this. Don't miss it. We're back to Bridges going for $10,000. 15 seconds on that clock, please. Good luck, Velda. Clear that mind. Name something that Americans spend lots of money to buy.
Baseball tickets.
The day you do your laundry.
Monday.
The toughest sport to train for.
Basketball.
The age when men become grandfathers.
42.
Something you see inside a boxing ring.
Boxers.
Turn around here, Velda. Let's see how you did. That's five answers. I asked you to name something Americans spend lots of money to buy. You said? Surprisingly, baseball tickets. Our survey said? Zero. The day you do your laundry. You said? Monday. Our survey said? 48. Basketball survey said zero. The age when men become grandfathers, you said? Age 42. Our survey said zero. Something you see inside a boxing ring, you said? Boxer. Survey said 35.
Yay!
All right, well done. Come on, Eleanor. Look straight ahead. Good luck.
Thank you.
You need 117 points as we put 20 seconds on the clock, please. Revealing your partner's answers, good luck. Listen carefully. Name something that Americans spend lots of money to buy.
Cars.
The day you do your laundry.
Saturday.
The toughest sport to train for.
Football.
The age when men become grandfathers.
51.
Something you see inside a boxing ring.
Gloves.
Turn around. You need 117. I asked you to name something that Americans spend lots of money to buy. You said? Cars. Survey said? 26 to over 100. Cars, the number one answer. I asked you the day you do your laundry. You said? Saturday. Our survey said? 33. 142. Monday, number one answer. The toughest sport to train for. You're 58 points away. You said? Football. Our survey said? 35. Number one answer was football. You're 13 points away. You gave us a prizing answer for the last two, which could take you over or not. The age when men become grandfathers, you said 51. Strange answer. If 13 people said it, you've got $10,000. What did our survey say? Zero. 50, the number one answer. You would have had the cash. Something you see inside a boxing ring, you said? Gloves. Did 13 people say gloves for $10,000? Our survey said only five. Referee, number one answer. $5 a point gives you $960. Come out here and hug it. We are going to come right back. Don't go away, please. Oh, you're so close. I'm Ray Combs for the Family Feud. We thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more of the Feud. See you next time. Bye-bye.
Let's meet the Bridges family. Cynthia, Velda, Elton, Eleanor, and Marilyn. Ready for action. Playing against the Billings family. Jenny, Julie, Bob, Kristen, and Kathleen. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Combs.
Welcome back, Bridges family. Hello, Billings family.
Woo.
Hello. We thank you so, so very much. We're going to have another great day of the feud. We've got a very special feud coming up starting February the 5th. Five of the greatest baseball players of our time, Dave Stewart, Ozzie Smith, Wally Joyner, Ellis Burks, Joe Carter, right here on the feud against five of the greatest umpires of our time. The men that called them out, be feuding it out right here on this show. Followed by our Tournament of Champions the next week, starting it. Top four money-winning families will take home a jackpot potentially of starting at $50,000 up to and over $100,000. A great month of feud in February. But today, we have returning as champions, hoping to make it into our overall Tournament of Champions. Welcome the Bridges family.
Yay!
How are you? Welcome.
How are you?
I'm doing very fine. Your family fell short of that big money yesterday, last time on the show.
Yes.
Who'd you bring to help you?
I brought my cousins with me again. Belda.
Hello, Belda.
Hey.
Cynthia.
Yeah.
Hello, Cynthia.
Hi.
Eleanor.
Hello.
And Marilyn.
Yay!
Welcome.
Yay!
Thank you. The game great yesterday, and today there are five wonderful family members here to defeat you. They are the Billings family.
Yay!
Hello, Julie. How are you?
I'm great.
My pleasure. Where is your lovely family from?
We're from San Diego.
San Diego, California. And who'd you bring with you?
I brought with me my older sister, Christy.
You had to point that out, my older sister. And who else you have?
My younger sister, Jennifer.
Okay, younger. And?
And my mother, Kathleen.
Your mother. Oh, you guys thought you could be sisters. And on the end?
And my father, Bob.
Welcome to Family Feud. Bob Billings. Somebody is going to play for $10,000. To do that, we've got to play The Feud. Come on, Elton. Let's go. Come on, Julie. Now, good luck. The first family to $300 will win the game, get a chance to play Fast Money for the $10,000. Here we go. We ask 100 people this question, and we put the top five answers on that board. Try to find the most popular answer to this question. Name someone it pays to be nice to. Elton?
Your parents.
How about your parents? Number two. One answer gives your family control. Julie, name someone it pays to be nice to.
How about a teacher?
How about a teacher? Bottom of the survey. You think of a steal? Come over with the Bridges family. Belda, you're back.
Yes.
You excited?
Yes.
I can tell.
Very.
All right. Now, here's your chance to take the bank in a clean sweep. We want you to name someone that it pays to be nice to.
Elderly people.
Elderly people.
Yeah.
Perhaps. Elderly people.
Oh.
Now, just because it wasn't on our survey doesn't mean you shouldn't be nice to elderly people. All right. Cynthia, welcome back.
Thank you.
You are so cute.
Thank you.
You're the one on the show last time when I asked a profession that known for playing around. You said, pimps! Name someone it pays to be nice to. You said?
A judge.
A judge?
Yes.
Yeah. Fine answer. Show me the judge.
Oh.
Two strikes and they're going for a steal. There's nearly $17 in this bank up for grabs. Eleanor would be ashamed to let them steal $17. Name someone it pays to be nice to. The number one answer sitting
I want my $17. Your boss.
Your boss.
Yeah.
It always pays to suck up to the boss. Number one. $64. Marilyn, keep it rolling. Someone it pays to be nice to.
Your children.
Pays to be nice to children. You're still alive if we see your children. No. Billings, they're going to take the bag unless you tell me one of those two answers. Name someone it pays to be nice to. Bob.
The police.
The police.
Kathleen. The principal.
The principal. Jenny?
The police.
The police?
How about your friends?
Oh, you're so sweet. Your friends. Okay, here. Over here, we hear pants! Over here. Julie, what do you say? Someone it pays to be nice to.
What do you say,
Kathleen?
I think
it's police.
Okay.
Police.
I'm going to say police.
Police over friends. Okay. You've got the bank. If one of those two answers are the police. Yes! Gives the Billings the bank. There's one answer we didn't know. Number four. rich relatives. It never hurts to be nice to anyone. Don't forget that. We're coming right back with more great questions, surprising answers after this. Come on, Bob. We are shooting. Right now, the Billings have $64. The Bridges, zero. We go, Belda, with another face-off. Come on, Christian. Well, it's been quite a while since I've done this, but I do feel a, quite a disadvantage. Two beautiful women, both taller than me. And there's only one reason, and it's taller than I. And also probably speak better than I. And the reason you're both taller than I is because you both have artificial footing underneath your feet. And Velda, if you give me those shoes, I'll become taller than you. And it's time once again to become tall man. Able to be taller than a woman. That's right, baby.
I'm making a
fantastic
statement.
You're making a fashion statement, and I'm showing that I have no ego problem. Here we go. The top six answers are on the board, you small, cute, petite women. In fact, Kristen, lose your high heels altogether just to give me the advantage. Be flat-footed. Here we go.
Here we go.
There we go. Now I feel like a man. Get a shot of this. Top six answers on the board. Name a job where people usually wear white pants.
Doctor.
She says a doctor. Number two, one answer, Kristen, gives you control. A job where people usually wear white pants.
I was going to say nurse.
Okay, maybe a nurse. Yay. Number one, a nurse. You think it's Belda? Just leave them off. You can take them with you. Jenny? They call me the equalizer. Name a job where people usually... Woo, come on, lighten up here, Kristen. Woo! There's some old readers. Maybe we'll give you some as parting gifts if you lose. Come on. Jenny, name a job. Woo! Name a job where people usually wear white pants.
How about a restaurant worker?
How about a restaurant worker? Hold on, the judge is kind of on one today. He says something specific. What kind of restaurant worker?
Fast food.
She says fast food. What kind of a worker? Faster food.
Food maker.
Food maker, she said, in time. Out. Okay, one strike. I'm sorry. The judge is really kind of on. Kathleen?
How about an ambulance attendant?
She says, an ambulance attendant.
Good answer, Mom.
All right.
Mom. Yeah. Hospital orderly, ambulance attendant, nine people. Bob, now listen carefully. Name a job where people usually wear white pants.
Dentist.
A dentist. Show me a dentist. Two strikes. Julie? Not so hard to walk in these. Name a job where people usually wear white pants.
How about an airline stewardess?
All right. Maybe. I've never seen them. But, let me see. An airline stewardess. All right. That's three strikes. Bridges, you have a chance to steal. With you, I can walk like a man. Name a job where people usually wear white pants.
A waiter.
A waiter?
A waiter.
Waiter, she said. All right. Eleanor?
A cook.
A cook?
Cook sounds good.
Cook sounds good.
A painter.
A painter, cook, Elton. There are three chances to steal the bank. What will you say?
I'm going to go with a cook.
He's going with a cook. If it's there, you have stolen the bank. Show me cook. Bam! You have the bank. $49. There are two answers we didn't know. A job where people usually wear white pants. Number three, painting.
Yeah,
I said that. Number five, a baker. We've got a close one that can go anyway. We're coming right back, and somebody's going to play for $10,000. Don't go away. See you in a minute. We've got a close one. The Billings are challenging with $64. The lead over the Bridges with 49 as we go. With another face-off. Come on, Jenny. Good luck, Cynthia. Two beautiful girls. And so for that reason, we will double the dollar value. Not really, we would have doubled it even if we're ugly men. Because it's that time in the show. The top five answers are on the board. We ask 100 people this question. Name a kind of place where you have to wait for a seat. What do you say, Jenny?
A restaurant.
How about a restaurant? Number one. You think of a seat. All right, Kathleen. You must be proud of these. Now, is this all the children that you have?
This is all. This is enough.
You did well. Three beautiful children.
Well, thank you.
Beautiful girls. Name a kind of place where you have to wait for a seat.
How about a doctor's office?
How about at a doctor's office? Let me see, perhaps. You got a little hair that's going right
oh,
in.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you so much for the touch.
Kind. Thank
Show
you.
Me a doctor's office. There you go. I keep the setting, Bob. Again, congratulations on your lovely family. What do you say? A place where you have to wait for a seat.
I'll say at the theater.
Okay, maybe the theater. Yeah. $160 in the bank. We go to lovely Julie, who keeps it rolling. What do you say?
How about for the subway?
Okay.
The bus.
You know what? You look at me like I'm a police officer, and with those eyes, I'm going to save you from getting a ticket. I can't help you, Julie. If I could jump back there and rewrite it, I would put it there for you, but I can't. You say maybe the subway, or what did you say?
The subway.
Subway. Show me the subway. Pretty amazing. I think your actual answer was subway or a bus, and they're both right there. Whew, okay. Kristen,
everybody
there's one answer.
My answer is
they
wrong.
Did?
Yes.
There's one answer, and your family has a very, very big lead. If you can name a kind of place where you have to wait for a seat.
Okay, restaurant's already said. Can you give me a hint?
Yes, I can. It's none of the other four.
Uh-huh.
3 seconds.
Theater.
Quickly. Okay, nice try. Jenny, you can bring it home. You can bring it home. Kind of place where you have to wait for a seat. Yes, you can.
Yes, I can.
You can do it. You can do it. 3 seconds.
An opera.
Wait for an opera. Okay, you wait maybe. Or an opera. There's one answer for the bank. And Kathleen, here's the question. Name a kind of place where you have to wait for a seat.
How about at the airline?
How about at the airline?
At the airline for a plane.
Show me, for that bank, the airlines. No. Bridges. They will have a very big lead if you cannot tell me. Number five, name a kind of place where you have to wait for a seat. Marilyn.
A hospital.
Hospital. Eleanor.
Church.
Church. Cynthia.
Pimps.
What do you say? Okay, she doesn't have one.
A concert.
A concert. Elton?
Hospital.
You can go with them or out on your own. There's many different answers.
Concert.
A kind of place where you wait for a seat. $192 is yours if it is...
A church.
Show me a church. No, the Billings take $192 more dollars, giving a bigger lead. This is a tough one. What is number five? Public. Not a good place to be waiting. $256 for the Billings. The bridge is 49, and we go. There's another face-off. Let us go. We will triple the dollar value at this time. Put the top four answers on the board. We ask 100 people. You guys all right back there? He says, all right. Name, here's the question. Name something in your home you turn down at night. Eleanor.
The heat.
Something in your home you turn down at night? The heat. Number one. Big, big bank. Keep it rolling, Marilyn. What do you say? Something in your home that you turn down at night.
The lighting.
Show me lighting. The other team can win, Elton. They can win unless you continue to roll. What do you say?
Your covers.
You turn down your covers. Either team can win if they give if they take this bank. Velda, give me number four. You're going to play for $10,000. What is it? Something in your home you turn down at night.
The music.
Show me the music.
Yay!
We strike all the Billings. Think of it still. Cynthia, time to come alive for the family.
Television.
You turn down for the game. The TV. Billings, think of number four. It's the only thing that will win you the game. What do you say?
The window shades, the drapes.
You turn down the window shades. The game is yours if we see the window shades. Billings, you're going to play for $10,000 if you tell me number four. Something in your home you turn down at night. Bob.
Does he?
No. Kathleen. She doesn't know. Jenny has no answer. The oven. Now, Julie. Julie, the A-team has been of no help to you.
Help.
If you give me number four,
anything.
You're going to play for $10,000. If not, it's the bridges. What is number four? 3 seconds.
How about the emergency system.
You turn down the emergency system.
No, you don't turn down the emergency system.
Okay.
Julie,
you're beautiful, but I don't think it's there, but I don't know. You're playing for $10,000 if we see the emergency system. No, you turned down your husband. Three people said that. Oh, well, I got to say goodbye to a wonderful family. Can you stay right here? We've got some nice, beautiful family. God bless you. Stay right here. I need two players for $10,000. Walter, you first. Bye-bye, Ellen. The Bridges playing Fast Money for $10,000. One more time. Right after this, please. You did it again. Good luck today. Give me 15 seconds on that clock, please. Time won't begin until I finish reading this first question. Good luck. Give me a word to describe the sound that water makes.
Drip.
Something people do to corn.
Eat it.
Something people take to the gym.
A bag.
A famous park.
MacArthur.
The earliest hour you came home from a date.
11.
Turn around. We asked 100 people these questions. Give me a word to describe the sound that water makes, you said. Drip. Survey said. 16 on the board. Something that people do to corn, you said. Eat it. Our survey said. 18. Something people take to the gym, your choice. A bag. Our survey said. 13. Slow but sure. A famous park, you said. MacArthur Park. Our survey said. Someone left the cake out in the rain. The earliest hour you came home from a date, you said? 11 o'clock. Our survey said? 14. Recover those answers. That is not bad.
All right.
It leaves a little work for your cousin Eleanor. Come on, Eleanor. Take a look. You need 139 points. It is not as difficult as you might think. Give the best answers you can think of to the five questions that I ask you. If you hear this sound, it means you have duplicated one of your partner's answers, and I'll say, try again, you give me another answer.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
A little more difficult, so five more seconds on the clock. 20 seconds, please. Revealing your partner's answers. Good luck. Give me a word to describe the sound that water makes.
Swoosh.
Something people do to corn.
Eat it.
Try again.
Pop it.
Something people take to the gym.
A garment bag.
Try again.
Wait.
A famous park.
Griffith Park.
The earliest hour you came home from a date. Your plane missed it. All right, turn around here. All right, you got to do it in four questions. Give me a word to describe the sound that water makes. You said the very definite sound of swoosh. Water, when it hits, just goes swoosh. Our survey said, four people said swoosh. The number one answer was splash.
Oh, okay.
Splash over swoosh, most people know. Something people do to corn, you said they pop it. Over Redenbacher might. Our survey said, 17. Good, good. Shuck it, number one answer, shucking of corn. Something people take to the gym, you said they go to the gym carrying weights. Why go if you're going to carry them there? Our survey said zero. Number one answer was gym shoes and towel. A famous park in L.A., you said? Griffith Park. Our survey said zero.
What?
Yellowstone Park, number one, tied with Jellystone. All right, Yellowstone all alone, number one. The earliest hour you came home from a date, you said? Boy, that buzz is so loud.
It
82
is.
82 points at $5 a point gives you $410, 10 p.m., number one answer to tie from the date. Come out here and hug her. The Bridges are still the champions. We're going to come right back. Just away. Oh, you guys are breaking my... For the Family Feud, I am Ray Combs. We thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Let's meet the Bridges family. Cynthia, Velda, Elton, Eleanor, and Marilyn, ready for action. Playing against the Chau family. Audrey, Bill, Tom, Andrew, and Sandy, on your mark. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray.
Thank you so very much. Will you welcome the lovely Bridges family?
How are you?
Well, I couldn't be better.
Yes.
We're very proud to have your family back. You have been up twice for the big money, and two times you've broken my heart.
We're going to get it.
Who'd you bring?
Yes.
Who'd you bring?
I brought my lovely cousins with me again.
They are?
Belda.
Hi.
Hi, Belda.
Cynthia.
Hi.
Hi.
Eleanor.
Hello.
Hello.
And Marilyn.
Hi.
Welcome to the feud. I hope I'm saying this name right. They're a very lovely family. The Chau family, am I saying it right?
Yeah.
Audrey, pronounce that name for me. Chau?
Chau.
Chau, okay.
Yeah.
Who did you bring to help you become
champion? Okay, I brought my brother Andrew.
Hi.
My
Andrew.
Cousin Bill.
Hi, Bill.
My cousin Sandy.
Hi.
And my cousin Tom.
Hello, hello. Cousins. All right, Chau family. Somebody is going to play for $10,000. But to do that, we have got to play the feud. Let us go, Elton. Let us go, Audrey. The first family to $300 will win the game, get a chance to play Fast Money for $10,000. Good luck. Here we go. We ask 100 women this question, and the top five answers are on that board. Try to find the most popular answer. Now remember, we ask 100 women. Name something you wish your husband did more of. Audrey.
Make love.
Make love. Audrey, stay here. Not a bad answer. Elton, remember, we ask 100 women. There's something you wish your husband did more of. You said?
Buy you nice things.
You, most women wish their husbands would buy them nice things.
Good answer.
Nobody move. Now listen to me, Andrew. This was, we ask 100 women. Name something you wish your husband did more of.
How about cook?
Yeah!
Okay, we'll see if it's there. Wait a minute. The judge says that's the same as making love, cooking. No. Here we go. Show me cooking. Not there. Keep this question alive, Velda. Name something you wish your husband did. We ask 100 women. What did they say?
Take you out more often.
How about take you out more often? Number two. Here we go. Right over this way. Cynthia? I can't wait to hear your response. We ask 100 women to name something that you wish your husband did more of. Audrey has already said, have sex, make love, anything that could involve a pimp in any way. Okay? So, what do you say?
Make repairs on the house.
Make repairs on the house. More home repairs. Chau family, you may get a chance to steal. Eleanor? Something you wish your husband did more of.
I'm going to go with housework.
More housework.
Good answer. Good answer.
Show me more housework. Number one. And goes up to $42. Marilyn, we ask 100 women to name something you wish your husband did more of.
Made more money.
Yes, money. Good answer.
Greed, 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 Marilyn. Show me that most women wish their husbands did more of, made more money. That's two strikes. I think that's called counterfeiting, Marilyn. Elton, name something you wish your husband did more of. What do you think they said, Elton? Those women, you never know, 100 of
help
them said.
Help take care of the kids.
Good answer.
Darn good. Answer. You're still alive if we see help take care of the kids. $42 coming to Chau's way. If you can name something you wish your husband did more of from 100 women's perspective, Tom?
Pay more attention.
Pay more attention to them. Sandy?
How about appreciate them?
Appreciate
pay more attention to them.
Pay more attention. Appreciate Andrew?
Take out the garbage.
Take out the garbage. Sensitive,
he's not
sensitive,
a husband.
Physical. Okay, there's a lot
right,
of...
guys, come on.
More attention.
More attention.
More attention.
More attention to the wife.
More attention.
Okay. Pay more attention.
Pay more attention to the wife and you're going to steal $42. Show me. Pay more attention. No! The Bridges, take that back. You know, we laughed at your answer, but I thought it was good. But it's not up there. 100 women, name something you wish your husband did more of.
What was number three?
Stay home.
Number four.
Exercise.
I didn't ask. Number five.
Kiss me.
If you kiss them, you start to exit. Never mind. We're coming right back. You never know the answers to the questions on our surveys. We're coming right back with more fun. Don't go away. The Bridges have $42, zero for the Chau family. We go! Let's go, Andrew. Good luck, Velda. Top five answers are on the board. Tell me a question a child would ask his mother. Andrew.
Where do babies come from?
Yeah!
All right. All right, Andrew. Show me. Where do babies come from, mother? Andrew, if a child asked you that in 50 words or less, how would you explain it?
I still don't know.
Are you married, Andrew?
No.
Okay, Andrew, nice talking to you. Bill.
Yes.
Tell me a question a child would ask his mother.
Can they go out to play?
Let me see. Can I go out to play?
Yeah!
Good answer. Andy, what do you say?
Hi.
Tell me. Hi, welcome officially.
Thank you.
Tell me a question a child would ask his mother.
Can I watch another television program, please?
Yeah.
Over Family Feud?
Never, never.
Okay,
all always right. Family Feud,
okay.
Always Family Feud.
Let me see, can I watch my TV, Mommy? Tom, tell me a question a child would ask his mother.
Do I have to go to bed now?
Yeah.
Good answer, good answer.
Show me, do I have to go to bed now? Bridges, you're going to get a chance to steal $64. But
okay,
Audrey's
I got it.
She's got it. I got it.
Okay,
what is it?
All right, can I sleep over my friend's house?
Can I sleep over my friend's house? Okay, you get a chance to steal. Bridges, you must give me one of those three. Tell me a question a child would ask his mother. Ma'am.
Do I have to go to school today?
Do I have to go to school, Eleanor?
May I have something to eat?
May I have something to eat, Cynthia?
Can I go to Disneyland?
Can I go to Disneyland? Cynthia, you know I love you. But being on the show for 3-4 days, your answers have varied. From goofy to a pimp, you know? I don't... What do you say about them?
Can I have some candy?
Can I have some
yeah.
candy? Elton, you can go with your family. Out on your own. 3 chances to steal that bank. What would one be?
Can I have something to eat?
Show me for the steal. Mom, can I have something to eat?
Yeah!
You got the steal. There's 2 answers we didn't know, child family. Something a child would ask his mother. Number three. Why?
Wow. Yes.
Why did you hit me upside my head? Show me. Number five. What time is it? It's time to watch the very important message, after which we're going to keep playing for the chance at $10,000. Welcome back to the feud. Right now, the Bridges, $106 on the way to $300. The Chau family, zero, as we go with a number one song. Come on, yeah. Bill, good luck. Here we go. We are going to double the dollar value. We have Bill, who is in the open stance position, one leg braced, ready to slap that buzzer. Cynthia, in the close-up position, ready to give any answer that could pop out of her head unpertaining to any question. With that warning to all of America, with small children, I ask this question. We are not responsible for the answers given by our contestants. Name something you see in a doctor's office. Bill.
A nurse.
He says he sees the nurse. Number two, one answer gives you control, Cynthia. Name something you see in a doctor's office.
The doctor.
Could it be the doctor? Bottom of the survey, 3 people said it. You think of a skill. Chau family or chance to take the lead. The dollar value's double. The clean sweep could give you the lead. What do you say, Sandy?
How about a tongue depressor?
Oh, that's my favorite. You stick it so far back, you go... Show me a tongue depressor. Nothing more than a gigantic popsicle stick without the popsicle. Tom, something you see in the doctor's office.
Thermometers.
Yeah.
Thermometers.
Yeah. Good answer.
answer.
It is a good answer. Show me thermometer. Tom, I thought it would be there. All the answers are good ones. They just haven't made our survey. The number one answer is there. And Audrey,
okay,
you can give it to me. Now listen carefully. Name something you see in a doctor's office.
Patient.
Could it be?
Yeah.
Patient. Yeah. Every one of those answers were very, very fine, but they didn't make the survey. Puts $44 in the survey. Here we go. Now, name something you see in a doctor's office.
A stethoscope. Magazine.
Magazines.
Syringe.
Syringe.
Medicine.
Medicines. Elton, you can go with him. We're out on your own. What do you want to say? What do you say?
I'm going to go out on the limb.
Uh-huh. Yes, yes.
On a table.
You say a table?
Doctor's table.
Doctor's table.
Examining table.
Examining table. Examining table. All right, if it's not on, it's not out there, that limb has been sawed off, Elton. Show me. For the bank, the doctor's table. Not there. The child family takes back. Bank. And the game. Now, I want us to all pay attention to these answers. This is surprising. We didn't know number one. The question is something you see in a doctor's office. What is number one? Magazine.
Magazine.
Said by?
Eleanor.
And number three? Stethoscope. Said by Marilyn. What is number four? Diploma. Number five?
Scale.
Right now, it is $106 for the bridges, $44 for the child, and we go with another face. Eleanor, good luck. The dollar value will be tripled. The top four answers are on the board. And here's a very thought-provoking question. Name an occupation in which women have to put up with men making passes at them. Sandy.
How about a nurse?
How about a nurse?
Yeah.
It's not there, Eleanor. Name an occupation in which women have to put up with men making passes at them.
Modeling.
Good answer.
Could it be modeling? Yeah. Number four. Think of a steal. Yeah. Dollar value's tripled here, Marilyn. This is a chance to use that brain that they passed up last time. An occupation in which women have to put up with men making passes at them.
A doctor.
We're going to beat that to death. Okay. Show me a doctor. All right, Elton. Name an occupation in which women have to put up with men making passes at them.
Table makers.
A stewardess.
Show me a stewardess. Bottom of the survey, flight attendant. Velda, you got number one, two, and three there. What do you say?
A lawyer.
Lawyer?
Yes.
Female lawyer?
Maybe.
Okay. All right, show me a lawyer. What do you say, Cynthia? They're going to try to steal, and you've always been one to come up with great answers. The question, name an occupation in which women have to put up with men making passes at them.
An actress.
Yes!
An actress.
Good answer.
Business exec.
How about a business executive?
Good answer.
Three strikes. Chau family, you'll be in the game. Name an occupation in which women have to put up with men making passes at them, Tom.
Cocktail waitress.
Cocktail waitress, yeah. Sandy.
A secretary.
Secretary.
Waitress.
Waitress.
Secretary.
She says secretary. Show me secretary. You've got the name. $60 coming your way. That was number one. Occupation. The women have to put up with them making passes. Waitress, barmaid. $107 for the Chows, $106 for the bridges. $1 lead as we go to another face off. Here we go. Come on. It's Tom against Marilyn. The dollar value is tripled. The top four answers on the board. Listen carefully. As I ask the question, we will go very quickly. Name something that causes a lot of auto accidents. Marilyn.
Alcohol.
She says alcohol. Number one, Elton, name something that causes a lot of auto accidents.
Drugs.
Good. Show me drugs.
Good
answer. Not there. $156 as the bank goes. Velda.
Bad drivers.
Could it be bad drivers? Not there. chance to steal the bank. What do you say?
Failure to yield.
Show me failure to yield. No chance. Name something that causes a lot of auto accidents. What do you say, Tom?
Icy roads.
Icy roads.
Speeding.
Speeding.
Bad weather.
Bad
icy
weather.
Roads.
Bad weather.
Bad weather, icy roads. What do you say, Andre?
I say bad weather.
Audrey says bad weather. You have got the bank. Two answers we did not know. Number three. Speeding. Number four. Girl watches. $263 for the Chau family. The Bridges have 106. And we go with another face-off. Let's go. The top four answers are on the board. The dollar value is tripled as we ask this question. Name something people put in a thermos bottle. What do you say, Audrey?
Quickly.
Hot tea.
She says hot tea. Not there. What do you say, Elton?
Coffee.
Show me coffee. Bam! Number one, you think of a steal. You'll win the game. You take this question down to something people put in a thermos bottle.
Soup.
Show me soup. Bam! Cynthia, what do you say?
Tea.
Could it be tea? Already said. It's already been said. Quickly. Show me. She says milk. Is that what you say specifically? Milk? Specifically, name something people put in a thermos bottle.
I don't understand what he said.
The question is, name something people put in a thermos bottle. What kind of tea?
Lipton tea.
Well, you can't really get more specific than that. In fact, you should give us some commercial money on that one. Show me Lipton tea. Not there. Audrey said what? Audrey said hot tea. Not given. I mean, not theirs. Eleanor, name something people put in a thermos bottle.
Iced tea.
Show me iced tea.
Yeah.
Marilyn, something people put in a thermos bottle.
Hot chocolate.
Yeah. Could it be for the game? Hot chocolate.
Come on.
Yeah. Yeah. This wonderful family. You played so well. You got nice parting gifts, and I want you to stay
Thank
right
you.
Here. God bless
Thank
you. Very
much.
Stay right here. I need two players for $10,000. One more time. Let us go. The Bridges. First with Elton. Bye-bye, Eleanor. We're coming right back for $10,000. Don't miss it. The Bridges going for $10,000. 15 seconds on the clock. Please, Elton up first. Good luck, my friend. Name a specific item of apparel both men and women wear.
Shoes.
An American, any American coin.
Nickel.
The earliest hour you'd have a drink.
4 o'clock.
Something you do to get ready for work.
Get dressed.
A fruit you squeeze to see if it's ripe.
Orange.
Turn around here. Let's see what you did. There's five answers. Specific item of apparel both men and women wear. You said? Shoes. Survey said? 8. Any American coin. You said? The nickel. Survey said? 14. The earliest hour you'd have a drink, you said. 4 o'clock. Survey said 14. Something you do to get ready for work. Your choice? Get dressed. Survey said 28. A fruit you'd squeeze to see if it's ripe. You said orange. What did our survey say? 15.
All right.
Your
right.
Answers are 7 or 9. You bring an Eleanor, your cousin, who's been kept off stage. Come on, Eleanor. You need 121 points. You can do it, but straight ahead. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck as we reveal your cousin's answers. Here we go. Name a specific item of apparel both men and women wear.
Shoes.
Try again.
Blouse, shirt.
Any American coin.
Nickel. Quarter.
The earliest hour you'd have a drink.
5 o'clock.
Something you do to get ready for work.
Take a shower.
A fruit you squeeze to see if it's ripe.
Melon.
What kind?
Cantaloupe.
All right, she says a cantaloupe melon. All right, here we go. Name a specific item of apparel both men and women wear. You said? A shirt. Our survey said? 2. Jeans, number one answer, not given. Any American coin, you said? Quarter. Survey said? It's 37, number one answer. The earliest hour you'd have a drink, your choice? 5 o'clock. What did our survey say? 18. Noon, number one answer. Something you do to get ready for work. You said? Take a shower. Our survey said? 40. Yeah. Take a shower, number one answer. 16 points away. A fruit you squeeze to see if it's ripe. You said? A cantaloupe. If 16 people said it, you've got $10,000. What Did our survey say? Oh, no! Number one was peaches. $5 a point gives you $965. Coming, Hugger. We are coming right back. Please don't go away. You folks are... I'm Ray Combs for Family Feud. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.
Let's meet the Bridges family. Cynthia, Velda, Elton, Eleanor, and Marilyn. Ready for action. Playing against the Bowen family. Jason, Susie, Mike, Christy, and Todd. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. Todd from Family Feud, Ray Cole.
Thank you very much. What a wonderful audience, please. We thank you so much. We ask the crowd to come to a hush as the quarterback will. We thank you so much. And those tuning in at home, I want to alert you to a very special month of feuds coming up in February. Starting February the 5th, we've got five of the greatest ball players in baseball of our time. Dave Stewart, Ozzie Smith, Wally Joyner, Ellis Burks, and Joe Carter playing against the umpires who have called them out. That's going to be great. And in February the 12th starts our Tournament of Champions, where the top four money-winning families get the chance to win a jackpot of over $100,000 potentially. But today, we have two families that are still eligible to make it in that tournament. Returning as champions, I believe, for the fourth time, they are the Bridges family. Yay! Your family has $3,375, but you could have $33,300. And you've come close three times, and today I wish you a lot of luck.
Thank you.
You must
Thank
win
you.
The game. Who did you bring to help you do it?
My cousins, Velda.
Yes. Hi.
Cynthia.
Yes.
Eleanor.
Hello.
Welcome back.
And Marilyn.
Hi.
It's nice to see you.
Yes, yes.
Here's a family that would take your crown and play for that $10,000. Will you welcome the Bowen family?
Yay!
How are you, Susie? Little cold hand?
I am cold.
Where's your family from?
From Fresno, California.
Yes, Fresno, welcome. Who'd you bring with you?
This is my husband, Jason.
Welcome, Ray. Jason.
This is my sister-in-law, Christy.
Welcome Hi, to the feud. And down there?
This is my brother-in-law, Todd.
Hi. Howdy, Todd. And on the end?
And my father-in-law, Mike.
Well, welcome Hi. To the feud. All right. Are you ready?
We're ready.
Somebody will play for that $10,000, but to do that, we've got to play the feud. Let's go, Elton. Let's go, Susie. Here we go. Good luck. The first family, the $300, will win the game, get a chance to play fast money for the $10,000. Here we go. We ask 100 people this question, and we put the top five answers on that board. Try to give me the most popular answer to this question. Name one way a liberated woman might surprise her date. Elton. Okay. Susie. See, she thought, and then, you, what do you say, Susie?
Ask him for a date.
Ask him for a date. Show me. Ask him for a date. It's not there. Hold on. We now go, I do believe, to Velda. Velda, name one way a liberated woman would surprise her date.
You pay the tab.
You, in other words, she would pay the tab.
Yes.
Show me she pays the tab. Number one answer you think of the field. Is there any way to teach that liberated stuff to your wife?
Of course not.
No.
She's trained already.
Oh, she is. Okay. All right. Cynthia, welcome back.
Thank you.
It's been a pleasure having
yes,
you on
it
the
has.
Show. For all the folks who have not seen you here on the show, they know the wonderful responses that you give. Name one way a liberated woman might surprise her date.
Opening the door for him.
Opening yes! the door for him. Yes! Let's see. Opening the door.
Yes!
The liberated woman opening the door and saying, get the hell out of here right now. What do you say, Eleanor?
By driving, picking him up.
By driving.
Yes!
Let me see. She picks him up. the last two might not be that easy. Marilyn, welcome back. And
thank you.
Tell me one way a liberated woman might surprise her date.
By planning the evening.
She would plan the evening. Let me see. She plans the evening. That is strike one. Elton, name one way a liberated woman might surprise her date.
By buying him clothes.
Good answer. Okay. Honey, I've been noticing you've been naked on all these dates. Here is some clothing. Not there. Bowen family, you're going to get a chance to steal. If Velda can't tell me, a way a liberated woman might surprise her date.
By fixing the dinner.
She would fix the dinner?
Yes.
Good answer! Velda, whenever the other team says it's a good answer, that means it was good for them. A liberated woman would never be the only one to fix the dinner. That's three strikes. $78 is going to come the Bowen's way if you can name one way a liberated woman might surprise her date. Mike.
She might take him a present.
Take him a present, Todd.
Yeah, take him chocolates.
Take him chocolates. Christy?
Sock him in the nose.
Sock him in the nose. All right.
Make the first move.
Make the first move.
Yeah.
Which would be like, what, pawn right to what?
Yeah, just kind
of. Make the first move, which could be punching him in the nose. Okay. Now, Susie, you can go with any of those fine answers. There are two that will steal you the bank. What do you say?
Well, Ray, I make better go with move. My husband make and say, move. Make the first move.
She would make the first move. Okay, now, well, let me just get this straight. You're there. We're the date, you and I. You're the liberated woman.
Mm-hmm.
What would be the first move? Or watch it.
I can't do it on TV.
That would be the first move? Would you? Oh, okay. All right, show me. She would make the first move. There it is. Make a pass. You got it. Sorry, I'm very sorry. But that's what you'd do, huh? One answer we didn't know. Number three. That's why I always rub their backs. We're coming right back. Don't go away. We are feuding. The Bowens have $78. The Bridges have zero. We go. Velda with another place. We put the top six answers on the board. We ask 100 people. Name an occupation whose members come to your house frequently.
Velma. Insurance salesperson.
Show me the insurance salesperson.
Yeah!
Door-to-door salesperson. You think of a steal. Cynthia, I can't wait to hear your answer. Name, just so that you understand her, on a question asked in another day, name an occupation whose members, male members, are known to play around. She said pimps. So, you never know what's going to come out of this young lady's mouth. Name an occupation whose members come to your house frequently.
The mailman.
Good answer!
Yes.
Good answer!
Good answer! Cynthia says, the mailman.
Yeah.
Number two. Leave you alone? No, I'm just trying to give some insights to what could come out of your mouth. Eleanor, keep it rolling. An occupation whose members come to your house frequently.
Maid.
A maid?
Good answer!
Perhaps a maid. Strike one. Chill, crowd. Chill. It's not that bad. Because Marilyn can keep it rolling. What do you say?
The gardener.
Show me a gardener. Bowen, you will have four chances to steal that bank if Elton can tell me an occupation whose members come to your house frequently.
Newspaper boy.
Good answer. Good answer.
Let me see the newspaper boy. Yeah. Bottom of the survey. $56 there. Keep it rolling, Velda. What do you say?
A TV repair person.
Maybe. Okay. You're still alive if we see a television repair person. No, sir. You must steal if you want that $56. Occupation, whose members come to your house frequently. Mike.
The garbage man.
Garbage man. Todd.
The garbage man.
Garbage man, Christy.
Garbage man.
Garbage man.
There's the milkman.
Yeah.
The milkman, garbage man, Susan. You got your own going, Sam.
Yeah, it's the garbage man.
You've stolen the bag one more time. Let me see. Garbage man. You stole it again. That's 2 times. An occupation whose members come to your house frequently. We didn't know number 3. Meter. That's a good way to break in somebody's house, just come in their basement. Yeah, meter reader. Number 4. The plumber. We're coming right back. Don't you go away. There's a lot more fun. And there's no end. He's coming right after these messages. Come on back. The Bowen family has $134. The bridge is zero as we go. With another good luck, Cynthia. The dollar value is doubled. The top 5 answers are on the board. We ask 100 people this question. Name something you do too much of. Christy.
I watch too much TV.
Okay, except for the feud. She watches too much TV. Right, one answer gives you control. Name something you do too much of.
Exercise.
You do too much exercise. Show me too much exercise. Not there. Think of a steal. This is the first time that the Bowens have had control of a question. Now it's your chance to perhaps get to steal. What do you say, Todd, officially?
Well, I overeat.
Some people do overeat. Survey. 48 people said it. Mike, my man, what do you say? Something people do too much of.
Procrastinate.
Procrastinate.
Yeah.
Fine answer?
That's right.
Does the crowd know what that means?
Right.
I'll tell you later. Right. Show me procrastination.
Ray, that's okay.
That is okay?
That's okay.
Thank you, Susie, because you know one of the answers, and it is?
I think I do. I would say sleep.
Some people do too much sleeping. $136 in the bank. Jason, what do you say?
They spend too much money.
How about too much money spent? Go to the bridges. Christy, they're going to get a chance to steal, and they'll be $2 ahead of you.
I know.
What do you say?
Well, I work too much.
Some people do too much work.
There you go. Yeah.
Let me see. Too much work. Bridget, you'll have the lead if you tell me one of those 2 answers. Name something you do too much of. Marilyn.
Neglect your obligations.
Neglect your obligations?
Talking.
Too much talking, Cynthia? Don't know.
No.
Talking. Too much talking.
Too much talking.
You have stolen the bank in our head by $2 if we see people doing too much talking. You've got $5 and a $2 lead. Boy, oh boy. What was number 4? Moultrie. $136 for the bridges. The Bowens, $134. It's a tight one, and we go. With another face-off. Here we go, Tom. Against Eleanor, the dollar value is tripled. The top 5 answers are on the board as I ask this question. Name a sophisticated city.
Bob? Chicago.
Let me see Chicago. Yeah. Not there at all. Eleanor, name a sophisticated city.
New York.
Show me the Big Apple. Yeah. Number 1, think of a steal. You know, Marilyn, if your family takes this question all the way through, you could win the game. What do you say? A sophisticated city.
Los Angeles.
Yeah. Let me see. The City of Angels. Not there. Los Angeles, not there. Listen carefully to the question, Elton. It's very simple. Name a sophisticated city.
Washington.
Good answer.
Could it be? Washington. Washington, D.C. Zelda, name a sophisticated city.
Paris.
She goes outside of the United States and says, Petty! Oui, Petty! 55 people said it. Cynthia, 2 more answers, and your family will win the game. What do you say?
Japan.
The city of Japan. This is what I mean. You never know what's going to come out of this girl's mouth. The city of Japan. In the country of what? Japan. Japan. Show me the city of Japan. They fought for years to become a nation, Cynthia. Eleanor, they can steal if you don't give me an answer, and they will win the game. A sophisticated city. Take a guess. 3 seconds.
France.
Also, France. Could be there. Also considered by many around the world as a country. Show me France. Not there. Bowen, you have a chance to steal this game if you can name a sophisticated city. What do you say, Mike?
San Francisco.
San Francisco, Todd.
Rome.
Rome.
London.
London.
San Francisco.
San Francisco, London, Rome. Susie, what do you say?
London.
Two answers.
London.
San Francisco.
You say.
I would say San Francisco.
If it is not there, the Bridges will play for $10,000. Show me San Francisco. Yes! There's one answer that we didn't know. Number 3. Boston. I have to say goodbye to a great family. You've given us so much fun.
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
Thank
you. But I can't give you more money to take home, but I have a nice amount. Please stay with us, right? God bless you.
Thank
you. Made it real fun for us. I need 2 players for $10,000. The Bowen family. New champion. Christy's up first, playing for $10,000 after this. Don't miss it. 15 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck. Time won't begin until I finish reading this first question. Name the day of the week when you do your banking.
Monday.
A spice sprinkled in drinks.
Cinnamon.
Something you make from flowers.
A bouquet.
The age when kids start going steady.
16.
An amount traveler checks come in.
25.
Turn around. Christy. Right here, that's 5. The day of the week when you do your banking, you said? Monday. Survey said? 16. A spice sprinkled in drinks, you said? Cinnamon. Survey said? 32. Something you make from flowers, you said? A bouquet. What did our survey say? Excellent. At 83. The age when kids start going steady. Your choice. 16. Our survey said, bam! You're over 100. And amount traveler's checks come in, you said, $25. Our survey said, 4 people said it varies by now, 120. We'll put you back with your family, cover your answers, and your husband, Jason. Jason, take a look. You need $80. You look straight ahead. Put your toes right on that line. I will give you the same 5 questions I gave your wife. If you hear this sound, it means that we have a man not doing his job on time. It means you duplicated their answer, and I'll say try again. You give me another answer. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Bring it home.
Okay.
20 seconds on the clock, please.
Got it.
Good luck. Name the day of the week when you do your banking.
Monday.
A spice sprinkled.
Friday.
A spice sprinkled in drinks.
Pepper.
Something you make from flowers.
Pass.
The age when kids start going steady.
16.
Try again.
17.
The amount traveler's checks come in.
$100.
Something you make from flowers.
Cookies.
Turn around here. You know something, Jason? I hope your other 4 answers get you 80 points.
Good answer. I hope so.
Because I've never seen a...
That's tough.
What kind of cookie is made from a flower? The daisy cookie?
Daisy cookie.
The daisy cookie.
Yeah, daisy cookie.
Or the daffodaisy cookie. Name the day of the week. Boy, I hope you did good on those other 4. Name the day of the week when you do your banking. You said? Friday as a second choice. Our survey said? Bam! I'll cover it, Jason. I never doubted you. Friday, the number 1 answer. A spice sprinkled in drinks. You said the popular drink of pepper in your drink. Achoo! Survey said? 3. You are 11 points away. Nutmeg was the number 1 answer. You're 11 points away. This could be the 1 answer to take you over the top. Something made from flowers, you said? Flour cookies. If 11 people said it, you got $10,000. And in fact, if it's there, I'll write you a personal check for $10,000. That's how bold I am. Our survey said... zero! Cake, the number one answer. No, I'm kidding. It was bouquet. The age when kids start going steady. 11 points away, you said? 17. Our survey said? Zero. 16, number one. It comes down to one question. The amount traveler's checks come in. You said? $100. If 11 people said $100, you've got $10,000. Our survey said? Yay! Right back. Please don't go away. I'm Ray Combs for the Family Feud. And thank you for watching. We will see you next time.
Let's meet the Bowen family. Jason, Susie, Mike, Christy, and Todd, ready for action. Playing against the Freed family. Randy, Wendy, Joe, Lisa, and Phil. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Combs.
Will you welcome the Bowen family? How are you?
We're glad to be back.
You are?
We are.
You won $10,338. A couple or more of those, and you may be one of our top four money-winning families to be in that tournament of champions with a potential jackpot of over $100,000. Who'd you bring?
Well, this is my husband, Jason.
Welcome back, Jason.
Thank you.
This is my sister-in-law, Christy.
Hi, welcome.
Ray. This is my brother-in-law, Todd.
Hello.
And my father-in-law, Mike.
Welcome back to Family Feud. Real cute family. It looks like they wanted to feed you. Will we welcome the Freed family? Where are you from, Lisa?
San Diego.
San Diego, drove all the way up?
Yes.
And who did you bring?
I brought my husband, Phil.
Hello, right. Phil.
And my brother, Joe.
Hi, Joe.
Hi.
Joe, I want you to try to contain the enthusiasm. I know it's captured within your body right now. You're trying to hold it back. And there, number four.
That's my sister, Wendy.
Hi, Wendy.
And her husband, Randy.
Welcome to Family Feud. Are you ready? Been waiting for a while. You've been practicing at home?
Yes, we have.
You might get the chance to play for that $10,000, but we've got to play the feud. Let's go, first family to $300 will win the game. Get a chance to play fast money for the $10,000. Good luck. Here we go. We ask 100 people this question. Put the top 7 answers on the board. Try to find the most popular answer to this question. And this is a great question. Name something you might do very badly the first time you try it. Susie.
Your driving test.
Okay. Very badly the first time you have your driving test. Here's the question. Name something you might do very badly the first time you try it, Lisa.
When you're learning to walk.
All right.
Child.
First time you try to walk. Not there. You think of a shoe. Now listen. Listen and think carefully. We ask 100 people this question. Name something you might do very badly the first time you try it. Sex. Sex. Fine.
All right.
Enjoy what 100 people would say. But look at her. Look at her. They had conflicting answers. All right. Christy, name something you might do very badly the first time you try it.
Ride a bike.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Again, there's 2 things they say once you learn to do them. Riding a bike and sex. That's right. And, of course, having sex on a bike. Show me. Riding a bike. Can I point out, one more person had trouble riding a bike than learning to make love. And Todd, the man who clapped so actively at Jason's answer. Now it's your chance. Name something you might do very badly the first time you try it. We got 4 answers there.
Speak in public.
The first time you ever try it, public speaking. Not there. But we come down into the anchor of the team, the strong man of the team.
There you go.
Who, what is it, Mike? What do you say?
come back. I had an answer, but it...
escaped you?
Yeah.
Something you might do very badly the first time you try it. You got 3 seconds.
Roller skate.
All right. Yeah. Show me roller skating. Roller skating. 14 people said it. Very fine job. Susie, name something you might do very badly the first time you try it.
I would probably say marriage.
Marriage. She says something you might do very badly the first time you try it. I'll try marriage. Didn't make our survey. Two strikes. Jason, they're going for the steal.
All right. You can do it.
Sing.
Everything you say rhymes with S's. I mean, sex, sing.
Sing.
Let me see. Singing. Free family. You can steal $41 if you can name something you might do very badly the first time you try it. Randy?
Cook.
Cooking.
Cook.
Cook.
Kissing.
Kissing.
Kiss.
Kissing and
kiss.
Cooking. Cook. Cooking and kissing. Kissing and cooking. Yes. What do you say, Lisa?
I'm
going
to say cooking.
Yes. Cooking? Yes. I've said it. I don't know. Again, I say, the judge says that kissing and cooking is the same thing. Once you get cooking, you kiss it. All right, show me. Show me cooking. You've stolen the bag. You didn't have trouble cooking, did you?
No.
All right. What was number one?
Skiing.
All skiing. And number seven? Swimming! We are coming right back. There's a slight lead, but it can go anywhere. You never know the answers to these questions. Don't go away. There is a lot more fun. We are shooting. Right now, the Free Family, $41. The Bowen, zero, as we go. Jason, with another big goal. The top six answers are on the board. We ask 100 people. Name an industry that didn't exist when you were born.
Phil. Computer.
Let's see the computer industry. Number one, kiss the feet of a steer. Oh, they kiss. I love that love thing you do. Joe. Joe, my friend. Speaking of kissing, is what you said as an answer last time. Name an industry that did not exist when you were born.
God.
3 seconds. Yes. Don't be. Judge, you can do it. Take a shot.
Television.
The television industry. Listen. We ask 100 people to name an industry that didn't exist when you were born. Show me TV. The crowd wasn't with you. But Joe, I knew you knew what you were talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
Wendy, name an industry that didn't... This is a surprising question. There are so many new inventions just in the last 50 years. Name an industry that didn't exist when you were born.
I'm going to say space.
The space industry. All right. Show me space. How you doing, pal?
Good.
Here we are. Can you name an industry that didn't exist when you were born?
Plastics.
Plastics didn't exist. Yeah. Plastics.
What do you see?
What's that? You're right, ma'am. What do you say?
I'm going to say automotive. I mean...
The automotive industry.
Yeah, the automotive industry.
Show me the automotive industry. Good try. Phil, one strike only. Name an industry that didn't exist when you were born.
Let's say genetics, microbiology.
Microbiology, genetics. Show me genetic microbiology. Bowen, think of a steal. Joe, now you can keep the family alive. Two answers there. Of 100 people that could have been any age, we asked the question, name an industry that didn't exist when you were born.
All I can think of is abortion. That's not really interesting.
Well, it is. We'll try it, see if it's there. There are abortion clinics, which is an industry. Years ago, it's kind of unheard of. Show me abortion clinics. Not there. Bowens, you can steal. Here you go. Name an industry that didn't exist when you were born, Mike.
The fast food industry.
Fast food industry. Todd.
Cellular phones.
Cellular phone industry. Christy.
Airline.
The airline industry. Jason.
Laser.
What's that?
Laser.
The laser industry? Yeah.
Airplane.
Which, okay. Susie, you can go before you speak. Whatever you say, we'll commit to the family.
Airline. Come on. Airline.
right.
You want her to say?
Yeah,
there's only two answers. What is it going to be?
Okay. I'm
going
to say fast food.
Fast food industry.
Yeah.
Okay. So what you're saying is that maybe 80 years ago, nobody ever said, you want fries with that?
That's it.
Okay. Show me the fast food industry. Bingo! You've got the lead. In an industry that didn't exist when you were born, number four. Disposable diapers. Thank God for technology. We're coming right back. Don't go away. There's a lot more fun right after this. We are back, and we've got a tight queue going on. The Bowens taking the lead with $83 on the way to 300. The Freed, 41 we go. It's another thing. Here, Joe. Joe, good luck. Top five answers are on the board. We will double the dollar value for this question. Double the dollar value. We ask 100 people. Name the occupation that, in your opinion, has the most masculine men. Christine.
Athletes.
Show me the occupation of athletes. Here we go. What do you say, Todd? The occupation, in your opinion, that has the most masculine men.
Police officers.
Show me
the
masculine police officers.
Yeah.
Not there, my friend. Mike, what do you say?
I would say actors.
Yes?
Yeah.
Show me Pee Wee Herman. Movie star. Movie star. Susie, you're rolling. The occupation, in your opinion, that has the most masculine men.
Ray.
Susie?
Physician.
Physicians have masculine men.
Yeah.
Let me see.
Yeah.
Doctors. We found a little hope. What do you say, Jason?
Here it is.
Models. Let me see.
Yeah.
Sure, they look good. Let me let me see. Models. Three strikes. Three family, $122 coming your way. The name of the occupation that, in your opinion, has the most masculine men.
Construction worker.
Construction worker.
What do you do, Randy?
Telephone company.
Okay, all right, Joe.
Military.
Military.
Construction.
Construction worker. The most masculine men are Lisa.
Construction.
What do you want her to say?
I'm gonna say construction worker.
You stole that bank, if we see. Construction workers. Two answers that we didn't know. I don't know if they're the most masculine, but I know of the three that are up here, they're the only ones that stand on top of 60 stories and go, Let me see, number four. Lifeguard. Yes, I know a few women that act like they were drowning just to get me to come out there to try to save them. You would? Well, I can't swim, but we'll give it a shot. Number five. Truck driver. You ever seen a truck driver naked? Not a pretty sight. $163 for the Freed family. The Bowens, 83 to go. Another face off. Here we go. Todd against Wendy. The dollar value is tripled. The top five answers are on the board. We ask 100 people this question as we move very quickly. Name something noisy in your house.
The stereo.
The noisy stereo. It's there, but three answers are more popular. Something noisy in your house.
The kids.
Show me the kids. Bam! You have got control. It's a tie. Excuse me. It is a tie. We come to the first family that said it first, which is the Bowen family. It both, even though one was a little higher than the kids, both people said these. I thank our judge one more time, Howard Felcher, for being on the job. Mike, what do you say? Something noisy in your house.
The television.
Could it be the television? What do you say, Susie? Something noisy in your house?
I would say the people.
Okay. Okay.
Oh, good answer.
Body language, she says. The people. Jason, something noisy in your house?
The washing machine.
Let me see a washing machine. Come on, Christy. They're going to steal a real big bank.
I have got it, Ray.
Okay.
It's the vacuum cleaner.
Yeah!
Yeah. I'm not going to say it because I know this crowd will boo, but if it's there, you're still alive. If not, that answer sucks. I knew you would boo! I knew this. Show me! It is a good answer. That's how I know it'll be there. Show me a vacuum cleaner. You need it now. There's enough money. They can win the game. What do you say? Something noisy in your house?
Because Christy makes me use it. The dishwasher.
Show me the dishwasher. $281 for the Bowens, the Freeds, $163. We go with another face-off. Randy against Mike. The dollar value is tripled. The top four answers are on the board. Here is the question. Name something people buy because it impresses other people. Dollar value tripled. Randy says.
Jewelry.
Jewelry. Number three. Two answers more popular, Mike.
Cars.
Let me see a car. Number one. Bowen family, you can win the game. What do you say, Susan? It is.
Clothes.
Show me clothing.
Yes.
It's there. One answer, Jason. You're playing for $10,000 more.
It's got to be a boat.
Show me for the game.
A boat. Yeah, a boat.
Hope for the Freeze. They can steal and win. Christy, something people buy to impress other people. What is it?
It's a house.
Could it be for the game? A house. Family, you'll get the chance to steal if Todd does not know. Something people buy to impress other people.
Motorhomes.
Could it be? A motorhome. It's not there. Hey, family, you must give me number four. They're playing for $10,000. Something people buy because it impresses other people. Randy.
A ranch.
A ranch. Wendy.
A fur coat.
A fur coat.
Furs.
Joe.
Furs.
Furs, furs, furs.
I'll say furs.
Furs. If it's not there, the Bowens are playing for $10,000. Show me. Fur coat. The family. They steal the game, and they're going to play for $10,000. Let me say goodbye. Your family's so sweet. And thank you for coming down from Fresno. You have $10,000.
Thank you.
Stay right here. You made it very fun. Don't go anywhere. I need two players for $10,000. Who's playing first? All right, bye-bye, Phil. The Freed family playing Fast Money for $10,000. Freed's the new champion, going for $10,000. 15 seconds. On the clock, please. Good luck, Joe. Listen carefully. We ask 100 people, name something you would expect to find in a man's purse.
A brush.
An entertainer involved in politics.
Pass.
A dangerous water sport.
Polo.
A birthstone.
Pass.
The waist measurement of the average man.
32.
A dangerous... Turn around here. You pass so many times, you confuse me, Joe. Name something you'd expect to find in a man's purse, you said? A brush. Our survey said? Zero. An entertainer involved in politics, you said? Pass. Survey said zero. A dangerous water sport, you said? Polo. Survey said? Zero. A birthstone, you said? Pass. Survey said?
Oh, my God.
I'll tell you something, Joe. I see a pattern forming here. I'll say one thing. Nobody can say you're not consistent. The waist measurement of the average man, you said? Size 32. You could throw us all off by getting some points here. Our survey said? 14. Some of those answers. Look straight at me. I want you to know, Phil. Look straight ahead. You need to just do your fair share, all right?
Okay.
If you hear this sound, it's a mistake because you gave an answer. Okay?
I gave an answer?
Your partner gave no answers, all right? Take a look. Take a look, Phil. Now, you can do this. I want you just to clear your thought process. If you think carefully, you can be the hero. It's been done before, and you can do it now. Give me 20 seconds on the clock. You listen carefully, you can go home the hero. Name something you expect to find in a man's purse.
Money.
An entertainer involved in politics. Quickly.
Jack Kemp.
A dangerous water sport.
Water skiing.
A birthstone.
Opal.
The waist measurement of the average man.
36.
Turn around. Bill. Name something you'd expect to find in a man's purse, you said... Money, our survey said 30. Money, the number one answer. An entertainer involved in politics. You said? Jack Kemp. He was a football player. Survey said? Zero. A dangerous number one answer, Ronald Reagan. He acted like president for 8 years. I voted for him both times, so I can't get letters either way. There you go. You know, you can't win. Why do I feel like this is the Morton Downey Jr. audience, you know? You just can't win. I love the man. It was a good joke, okay? And don't write me letters, okay? A dangerous water sport, you said? Water skiing. My manager was booing me over there. Survey said? 23. Scuba diving, skin diving, number one answer. I asked you a birthstone. You said? Opal. Survey said? 17. Ruby, number one. Waist measurement of the average man, you said? Size 36. Survey said? 33. That gives you 117 points, 34, number one answer, $5 a point, 585. Come and hug him. Come and hug him. We are coming right back. Please don't go away. All right.